This conference
ह्यूमन
will
रिसोर्स
now be
डेवलपमेंट
recorded.
सेंटर एस्टवाइन एकेडमिक स्टाफ कॉलेज गुरु जगमेश्वर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी हिसार. सी हैज पब्लिश्ड एंड एडिटेड वेरियस बुक्स रिसर्च पेपर्स एंड रिसर्च टूल्स. सी इज आल्सो अ मेंबर ऑफ वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस इंक्लूडिंग ऑल इंडिया एसोसिएशन ऑफ एजुकेशनल रिसर्च एंड काउंसिल फॉर टीचर एजुकेशन एंड इंडियन जर्नल ऑफ साइकोलॉजी एंड एजुकेशन. सी वॉज ऑल्सो अ कोर्स कोऑर्डिनेटर एट नेशनल रिसोर्स सेंटर MHRD Pedagogical Innovation and Research Methodology, Hisar. Now, I want to invite Professor Vandana Punia, ma'am, for his session, for our session on utilization of digital tools and techniques in effective teaching, research, and extension. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you,
welcome,
sir,
welcome,
for
ma'am.
Inviting me. Thank you, Dr. Manna, sir, Professor Dr. Manna, giving me this opportunity to speak before this enlightened group for digital tools and techniques. Thank you, sir. Before presenting my presentation, could I be a presenter of this seminar, sir?
You already, ma'am, you just look at the bottom, you can share the screen. My
okay,
camera
sir. Thank you.
Yes, yeah, please.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, before starting my session, I'm saying some few words. A rapid shift during this changed phase, the technology that received a hard push back suddenly becomes acceptable, even mandatory. This is a great surprise for all. COVID-19 has unbundled the education system globally. Prior to this situation, usually e-learning technologies attracted a small number of teachers. I personally observed that as and when there was a call for utilizing digital technologies tools in educational endeavors, mostly teachers hesitated to use the same. But now COVID-19 has brought new analyses of SWOT, strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and challenges for our educational system. And this SWOT for teaching technologies with reference to digital technologies will change our education system globally. With the outbreak of this novel coronavirus, there's emerging a trend to facilitate the online learning system. This is established fact where knowledge is a mouse click away. The educational system must change too. Now the question arises, that how can we collectively reimagine our educational system to be more agile, more flexible, and more resistant to such global crisis? So the topic of my topic is digital tools and techniques in effective research and extension. Now I am sharing my screen with my presentation. Sir, it is visible to all. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. It's very much visible. And you have to speak little yes, loudly please. Because some of the participants are saying that they could not hear. So little loudly, although it's everything is clear.
Okay,
thank
sir.
You.
Okay.
Thank
okay,
you.
Sir.
Thank you.
Now let us explore preparing teachers for 21st century utilization of digital tools and techniques. We should always remember the technology is to be used to supplement teaching, not teachers. Yes, technology can never replace the great teachers, but in the hands of great teachers, it can be transformational. I really support digital teaching based on flipped classroom learning approach. My focus area is, I have focused three main areas. Very first area is virtual classroom and e-content. The second is utilization of digital tools and technologies in effective instruction. And the third, the main concern of this pandemic COVID-19 is delivering of learning through online platform. These are three main focus areas. My very first area is virtual classroom and e-content. What is virtual classrooms and e-content? basically e-content facilitate to the virtual classrooms. Where there is no e-content, it means there is no virtual classrooms. Now, what is happening? Looking at present scenario, during lockdown, when every institution is closed, we teachers are sitting at home and trying to contact with our students, sending learning materials through our digital devices. Whatever it is, WhatsApp, whatever it is, email, whatever it is. The scenario reflects major changes in our education system. Yes, we are bound to switch our face-to-face classroom into our virtual classroom supported by e-learning technologies. And this is a forced instructions for teachers and students. It is always saying that invention is necessity is the mother of invention. So is the case with COVID-19. Now, virtual classrooms and e-contents are the necessity of this today's scenario. What is virtual classroom? Exactly, what is a virtual classroom? This type of learning requires enormous kind of e-content and various digital tools and techniques for effective delivery of learning resources. A virtual classroom is a software-based teaching and learning environment that mimics the qualities of face-to-face classroom. When we are attending our classroom on Zoom, 4 hours and 5 hours and 6 hours without any e-content, without any technology, it means this is not the synonymous of on-learning environment. On-learning environment is concerned with especially digital tools, technologies, and e-content. What is exactly in virtual classrooms? Virtual classroom is where teacher and learners can participate in live online classes, communicate with each other, hold discussions, synchronous and asynchronous, watch videos or presentation. Exactly, e-content facilitate to the online learning system. There is also established fact that online learning system is online learning environment is what? 75% is asynchronous and 25% is synchronous. And what is now happening in this scenario? 75% is synchronous and 25% is asynchronous. What is synchronous and what is asynchronous? In our further succeeding sections, we will explore is what is synchronous and what is asynchronous. And we must remember, and then when we generating our online learning environment, there must be 75% asynchronous and only 25% or 35% synchronous. Synchronous is just concerned with discussion, only discussion, only problems arising sessions, etc. Not even in our face-to-face classroom, when we speak before our students, within 1 hour, 2 hours, or 3 hours. No, this is not the condition or requirement of on-learning environment. Then what it needs? It needs various digital tools and technologies to create our e-content. E-content in form of which? Where a teacher creates his own imagination, innovation with his chapter. Our 21st century skills are concerned with 4 C's, creativity, communication, problem solving, and collaboration. When a teacher starts his chapter or his title, suddenly it doesn't end with just a verbal spoken speech. But it needs some skills, or it means some e-content based on digital technologies. What it can be? It can be a lesson ends up with some case studies, some simulations, some experiments, when I'm teaching a communication skill to my students, my work is with them. I have to give them the task to prepare a paraphrasing after learning grammatical correctness, after learning punctuations, after learning tenses, what they need, they must have the skill to prepare a paraphrasing. So our digital tools and technologies helps a teacher to prepare their e-content with various their imagination and innovations, which covers all four skills. Exactly, what is e-content? Generally, e-content is what? E-content is, it is called electronic content. And it is designed and developed by using digital tools and techniques. They are popular digital tools and technologies in our scenario. And also, there are much digital tools and techniques in research phase also. What are these e-content? Exactly, what are these e-content? These are text, images, graphics, animations, audio, and video. Before COVID-19, we have just used our PDFs. We have just type a message or type a lesson in MS Word and get it into PDF, and our PDF is ready and our notes are ready. But now, we are the emerging situation is what? It is just with the help of digital tools and techniques, there are various tools where we can prepare our e-content with immersive content, with artificial intelligence, with content authoring tools, much interactivity, much interface. Today's digital contents help us in navigation and interactivity with our e-content. And there's also a much confusion about e-content. What is e-content? E-content is just electronic content, but now debates are also raised in the such issues. If you are having an e-content, it means it should be the web links. So what we should do, we have some web links whenever we have created our e-content. E-content can be accessed, e-content can be generated. What are the e-content and the single, it can be single media, it can be multimedia. Depending upon the choices of the teacher, depending upon the need of the topic, depending upon the stakeholders. Exactly, what is e-content and what is not e-content? This is a debatable issue, but if we have e-content, we must have the web links. Gone are the days when we say that we are not able to create our e-content. Yes, we are able to do our e-content with the minimal knowledge of our computer understanding. In today's scenario, what is going on? Every teacher, every administration, every directorate of higher education, everyone is demanding our e-content. Whether we are not able to generate e-content, whether when we are generating our e-content with not full understanding of the tools and technologies, even when we are generating our e-content, this is fabulous. A teacher of 58 years, he is also trying to create her e-content. Why? Because he or she wants to contact his students in this COVID-19 way. It can be WhatsApp, it can be email, it can be open education resources. Now the situation is very drastic. When we are not generating our e-content, friends, there is no need to generate our e-content. If you are not comfortable, you can access the e-content with various open education resources. Swayam Prabha, there are EPG Pachala. You can access as it is with Creative Common License. You can access this e-content. You can upload this e-content to your LMS learning management system, and you can deliver this lesson. There is no need to create your e-content. Very first, you will access your e-content. Then you will try to generate your content. As and when you will be baptized to generating e-content, you will be perfect for generating e-content, and also you will be enjoying to generate e-content. This is e-content. How can this e-content be created? In further succeeding sessions, we will explore some tools. How can we create our own e-content? And this e-content is not, friends, just lesson plan, just PDFs. This e-content can be your MCQs, your Google Forms, your images, your videos, your skill-based lesson. This can be your e-content. Now the major focus of our this presentation is, now what are digital tools? As my picture shown, there are so many digital tools in my picture. Facebook, Twitter, Bing, there are so many. If you explore this picture, there are so many digital tools. Exactly, what are these digital tools? Digital tools are programs, websites, or online resources that can make our task easier and to complete. A lot of these can be accessed in web browsers without needing to be downloaded, and you can access them both at home and in work. Digital technologies are electronic tools, systems, devices, and resources that generate, store, or process data. A well-known example of these digital tools are social media, online games, simulations, multimedia, and various mobile apps and software applications, just like Kahoot, Padlet, Drive, etc. Before starting our online learning environment, or before started generating, I'm saying generating online learning environment, there are some related terms and associated terms. What are these? Very first, digital tools and services. What are these digital tools and services? These digital tools and services are concerned with online or offline tools and services, such as apps, websites, games, that can be used by educators to enhance learning and teaching in all curriculum areas. These are digital tools and services. Exactly, what are digital devices? This is also an associated term with online learning environment. And without digital devices, we can't generate our digital tools and services. What are these? It includes all your personal computers, your Macs, Chromebooks, laptops, iPods, and Surface tablets. These are hardware approach. And what are digital technology? I'm saying digital tools and services. I'm saying digital devices. Now I'm saying digital technology. What are digital technologies? These are digital applications. The term used to describe those digital applications, services, and resources which are used to find, analyze, create, communicate, and use information in a digital context. This is digital technology. This is also an important concept for generating online learning environment, friends. Synchronous and asynchronous. In our researches, in our digital learning technologies, there are many researches who are supported that there should be minimum synchronous and maximum asynchronous environment should be there. What is synchronous and what is asynchronous? Yes. Synchronous is what? Synchronous actions and happenings are time-bound. Working together at the same time, communication between two people requires them to both the present at time. Examples, your chat rooms, your online conferences, instant messaging, live webcasting, application sharing. These are synchronous actions. And what are the asynchronous actions? Asynchronous actions are not happenings, just your time-bound. This asynchronous communication is contrasted with your synchronous communication. Example of this asynchronous communication is email, your discussion forms, wikis, blogs, webcasting, where it covers the four A's of your learning environment: anywhere, anytime, any place, or for anyone. So this is my submission that we should go minimum synchronous and maximum asynchronous. Now we are coming upon our major part portion of this FTP program of this today's session is utilization of digital tools and techniques in effective instruction. Yes, very first is Google Drive as online collaboration and communication. We have also heard about Google Drive, and Google Drive is vast. जब भी मैंने Google Drive को जब भी जितनी बार भी मैंने सुना तो तब पाया कि yes, this is the most comfortable, important and significant tool for our generating online learning environment. What is Google Drive? Google Drive is a file storage and synchronization device developed by Google, launched on April 24th, 2012. Google Drive allows users to store files on their share files, link share facilities, and embedded file. Now, what is this Google Drive? If you are on your tablet, computers, or laptops, you can have witness of this Google Drive. Otherwise, I have some screenshot about how to operate the Google Drive. This is our Google Drive. This is the icon of this Google Drive. What this Google Drive is doing? It can store our files and folders. It can share our file with many collaborators. It can share the link when, as and when we have the big size of our files. We have a thesis, we have our books. Then we can share a link with the with anyone. We can embed the file. In many LMS, in many learning management system, where there is less space, we can share our files. We can share the link of our file. We can embed our file. We can embed the video. We can embed the image. So this is most important for generating an online environment. Then one must be know about Google Drive or functions of Google Drive. And this also a very surprising fact that when learning a Google Drive, there are three types of learner: beginners, intermediate, and advanced learners. I don't know those who are participating in this faculty development program, they lies in which category? They are beginners, they are intermediate, or they are advanced. But I am exploring the perspective of beginner, not an advanced one. What a Google Drive do? There are so many. These are the features: storage, sharing file, sharing link, and embedded file. There are some other standard characteristics of this. Not yet say characteristics. These are some elements of Google Drive: Google Docs, Google Separate Sheet, Google Forms, Google Meet, and Google Slides. And the most important for a creative teacher is Blogger. We will now explore what are these. What can we do when we start our G drive? Where is this G drive located, and how can it operate it? This is my first screenshot of this. Yes, it is changed. Storage of file and folders. First, how can we storage our files and folder into drive? जब भी हम ड्राइव की बात करते हैं, फाइल एंड स्टोरेज की बात करते हैं, अगर मुझे कहीं लेक्चर के लिए जाना है तो मुझे पेन ड्राइव रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. नो नीड टू कीप अदर एलिमेंट, नो नीड टू कीप माय नोट्स. व्हाट आई डू, आई जस्ट अपलोड माय स्लाइड, जस्ट अपलोड माय प्रेजेंटेशन इन ड्राइव, एंड एज एंड व्हेन देयर इज एनी कंप्यूटर और लैपटॉप और अदर स्टेशन, I will operate it. I will open my drive. I will open by click my presentation, and suddenly it appears on another laptop. This is the function of a good storage of D drive. What will we do? We go to Google. वेयर यू माय आई मुझे लगता है मेरा जो ये जो एरो है ये विजिबल होगा. इट इज विजिबल, माय एरो इज विजिबल टू ऑल. हेलो,
यस मैम, इट्स विजिबल, इट्स विजिबल.
एरो, एरो इज विजिबल टू, आई एम, आई एम सर्कुलेटिंग माय एरो.
योर कर्सर इज विजिबल.
ओके ओके मैम, ओके सर, थैंक यू सर. आई एम क्लिक्ड ड्राइव. वेयर इज ड्राइव? This is on Gmail, where your Gmail is appears, and the left side of the this icon, there are 9 applications, 9 dots. These 9 dots, and the page appears. As and when we click the drive, suddenly a page appears. Yes, the page appears. This is my drive. These are my files. These are my folders. And no one can access my drive without my permission. I will give the permission to access my file. Only then one can access my file. Otherwise, not. These are some files and folders. These are my files and folders. These files and folders can be uploaded by others also. Other will be shared also. This is file storage. How can I store this file and folders into D drive? I will click the new. This is below the drive, new. As and when I click the new, what happens? This appears, folder, file upload, folder upload, Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, more. Now what I can do? I click again on file upload. As and when I click file upload, जहां भी आपकी फाइल है, जिस भी लोकेशन में आपकी फाइल है, sooner or later it will be uploaded on your Google Drive. Whichever it is size, whichever it is position, it will be uploaded from your computer or from your location of your computer, whether it is E, whether it is C, whether it is D, whether it is your desktop. This is the process of file upload and folder upload. You can upload your file, you can upload your folder. The third is, we can use Google Docs. Very interesting, dynamic, and interesting Google Doc for me also. If house allow me, I can take an example of my scholar. Me and my scholar had worked till midnight on this Google Doc, where when her thesis was to be submitted, we have shared this Google Doc. अब ये जो गूगल डॉक है, आप जब सो देख रहे हैं गूगल डॉक, इस गूगल डॉक को मेनी पीपल कैन शेयर सेम फाइल विद सेम लिंक. दिस फाइल विल बी शेयर्ड बाय ऑल एंड द एडिटर विल अलाउ द पीपल टू एडिट देम. एडिटर विल अलाउ द पीपल नॉट टू एडिट देम, जस्ट टू कमेंट. ओनली एडिटर अलाउ देम टू जस्ट टू व्यू देम. हाउ कैन इट बी डन? Again, we are again our next presentation. As and when you open your Google Doc, there is a share. You can say you have share. Click the share. As and when you click the share, an icon appears, name before sharing. I have given the name Faculty Development Program. It's a file name, Faculty Development Program. I have saved the file. Now, the drive and Google Doc allows me to share this file with groups and share with the file. I will add the people and groups whom I want to share this file. See my presentation here, add people and groups. आप इसमें अपने जितने भी आपको 5, 6, 7, 8 जितने भी पर्सन हैं उनको आप शेयर करना चाहते हैं, एडिट करना चाहते हैं उनके साथ, एड देम, एड पीपल एंड ग्रुप्स. और इवन इफ यू आर नॉट नोन टू द ईमेल्स ऑफ द ग्रुप, यू कैन सेंड ए गेट लिंक. कॉपी द लिंक ऑन योर व्हाट्सएप एंड सेंड इट. दिस इज ऑल्सो अ कंडीशन of this Google Doc sharing collaborative platform. What it is, share with people and group with their names and emails, or we send links to the restricted to the people or anyone with the link. If your file go to the public domain, if you want to upload this file on a website where 1,000 people can see, what you will do, you will change the command, anyone with the link. Not necessarily to the people, anyone with a link, then this link will be in public domain. Same is the case. Now, we have also done so many experiments with the Google Docs. This is a blank document. You are seeing blank document. Even when there are so many templates. What is template? Template is a predefined design for anything. How can we access to the form template? Go to new, click the new, where document, this is a blank document, and this is the template. Clicking the template, what we find? Amazing. What will we find? You will find the template of a project proposal. You will find a template of a newsletter. You will find a template of a brochure. You will find a template of a meeting notes, certificates. There are so many templates that you want. So we have experimented a lot with this template. You can do also, go to Google Doc, click the new, click the template, whatever your need is, whatever it is, project proposal, what is newsletter, what is report, click it on. This is the template. Predefined designs, and your typed text will be pasted on this template, and you will be a remarkable research report, project proposal, or CV, your curriculum vitae. So many things are there in your templates. Same is why I'm saying about my template. Yes. Now the second thing. What can we do? Our Google Drive is with our Google Drive. You can embed your file. You can embed your video. You can embed your books. This is a major book for MTech students, pedagogy studies, education and education rigorous literature review, decided for AICT. There is a pedagogy studies for MTech subjects. I am teaching this subject, and this book is having a large size. What I can do, I can embed this file. How can I embed this file? This is a book. I have first uploaded the book in my Google Drive. Click the Google Drive. The page appears this. Where click? There are so many instructions. Share, move to, add star, rename, find, details, manage, comment notification, open in new video. If we want to embed our file, what we do? We will click open the new window. After clicking open in new window, again, the window appears, and here, embed item. What will we see? Embed item. Where it is? Share, organize, add star, rename, find, detail, send feedback. Last but one, embed item. We will click the embed item. What will we receive? We receive the link of this. Paste HTML to embed in website. You can paste this whole iframe to your website. This is then the whole book will be on your website, on your platforms, on your LMS. This is what we do. This you can embed your file. These are the functions of G Drive. You can link that here. You can embed the file. And as a digital learning beginner of digital learning person, we must know about how we link the file, how we embed the file. It is must to generating a learning environment system in a LMS, whether it is Moodle, whether it is Canvas, whether it is a Blackboard, whether it is every LMS requires less space. So for keeping a less space, we should give our files linking, sharing, and embedding item. Again, I have again the another example of link sharing and embedding file. Yes, I have created a Moodle site. On this Moodle site, I have to paste my university logo or university pictures. Moodle requires embed file. So I have embed my file in the Google system from this process. I can share the link with this image. I can embed the item with this link. We may have also more facilities. If we want to copy and paste any text from PDF, need not to go anywhere. What will we do? We do open, click the open, click the Google Docs, entire PDF is converted into Google Docs. Even then, if you want to convert your MS Word file into PDF, you can also convert your PDF file, MS file into PDF file with this Google Drive facilities. There are more facilities also. There's a text to speech, PDF viewer, PDF to HTML and PDF compressed file, translator for all languages also with three third party intervention. There are so many facilities in Google Drive with third party interventions. If you click on connect more apps, what it need? You need not to be typing the text. Just you go on speaking and it will be writing on MS Word. There are so many apps, but in using our apps or using the third party intervention, we must be careful from cybersecurity issues. So a digital learning expert always advises that use popular digital tools or so-called digital tools, which is going on your FT programs, your peers. So safe surroundings, bits of safeguarding, we must be must be aware for cybersecurity issues. Again, there is always a vibrating features of Google Sheets. It can be shared with many people. What are teachers are doing this? If I have given a subject and two or three teachers are coordinating the subject, one subject, और मुझे उसके awards लगाने हैं, A, B, C part, four teachers, same sheet हम लोग allocate करेंगे, तो blank sheet पर जाके हम लोग four segments लगाएंगे, A part को share करके एक teacher fill up करेगा, B part teacher share करेगा, C part को C teacher share करेगा. This is a collaborative platform for teachers. जब भी हम हमारे कोई NAC की कोई report तैयार करनी है, NIRF की कोई team तैयार करनी है, तो what will we do? We will have our separate laptops with a one big major your screen projector with your principal or with your convener. All teachers will work on their with their laptops, but the file will be the same. You can edit the file with same file, you can comment the same file, and you can view the same file. This is your Google Sheets. Google Sheet is most significant part of our online learning system. It is also have this two dimensions: blank separate sheet and from a template. What is your blank separate sheet? This is blank separate sheet. What can you can do anything from this template as much your requirement. It can be shared, it can be collaborated. And what is template? This is template. I have not taken a screenshot of template, but it is also amazing. Amazing, you can have the templates of your Google Sheets. This is Google Slides. Amazing. Again, it is much better as your MS PowerPoint. There are so many facilities in your Google Slides. A very big facility is there. I am fond of this facility. मैं और मेरे स्टूडेंट का वाइवा जब फिक्स होगा इन नोवल कोरोना वायरस में व्हेन वी आर नॉट इन आवर स्टेशन वी आर वर्किंग एट अवर होम व्हाट वी विल डू आई विल माय स्कॉलर विल शेयर दिस गूगल स्लाइड विद मी आई विल लुक एट दिस स्लाइड आई विल ऑब्जर्व दिस स्लाइड आई विल एडिट दिस टाइम अगर मुझे इसका थीम पसंद नहीं आया मुझे इसकी वर्डिंग पसंद नहीं आई मुझे इसका कलर पसंद नहीं है तो सडनली आई विल चेंज ऑटोमेटिकली आई विल चेंज दिस स्लाइड पहले क्या था कि हम लोग फर्स्ट माय स्टूडेंट विल सेंड ईमेल टू मी मैम प्लीज लुक एट माय पेपर प्लीज मैम लुक एट माय स्लाइड देन आई विल ओपन द ईमेल करेक्ट इट देन अगेन सेंड ईमेल टू हर It takes a lot of time. Google Slide, Google Docs, and Google Docs, they have spared our time a lot. Amazing. You can do it. You can do it collaboratively, your slide, your spreadsheet, and your Google Doc. You can write a paper with four or five members residing away kilometers from your home. You can collaboratively write it on it. There are so many features. Again, it has also the two facilities, your blank and your template. This is your template. Switching, yes. This is your template. There are so many templates, wedding, portfolio, lookbook, your big idea, general presentation. There are so many templates, as much as more. You can take it as you desired. These are the template gallery. There are so many features in Gmail. I have left it. I have left Google Forms. I have left now Blogger. I have left Photos. I have left Calendars because the session is too small. I have taken it only what I have taken. I have taken in Google functions of Google Drive, storage of files and folders, Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides, sharing file with many people's. Sharing link with restrictions and anyone with the link, templates, embedded file, PDF to Word and Word to PDF like facilities. Now the second is again webinar tools. Everyone is crying and locating about webinar tools. What webinar tools should be used to interact our students in our synchronous environment? How can we reflect our face-to-face classroom through webinars tools? How can we give our lectures, face-to-face lectures to our students? This is the concern of every teacher. What are these webinar tools? These are the list of webinar tools. Go to webinar, go to Meet, Cisco WebEx, Google Meet, Zoom 5.0, YouTube Live, StreamYard. This is an amazing, amazing broadcasting facility I have ever used about StreamYard. Facebook Live, Messenger with chat rooms, AnyMeeting, Skype, and Microsoft Teams. I have taken up one example of Google Meet. How can we synchronize our classes with Google Meet? Again, click on your Google Apps where you find Google Meet. Google Meet. This is the replacement of Google Hangout. With your personal ID, you can take up 100 participants. And with G Suite ID or institutional ID, you can take up 250 participants. But my concern is not organizing a webinar or a conference. My concern is only a general and common teacher who is willingly to take a class from his home with the Google Meet. Yes, you can make your Gmail account. Login, go to Google Apps and click Meet. As and when you click the G Meet, you can take up 100 participants or 100 students. at a time. After clicking the Gmail, the page appears. Premium video meetings now free for everyone. New meeting, enter a code link. If a teacher wants to schedule a class, then click on new meeting. Or if as a student or as a trainee, you will find a code link, then paste that code link on this segment. Again, I am a teacher. I want to schedule a new class. What I will do? I will click on new meeting. After clicking the new meeting, yes, the page appears. It gives us three options. Get a meeting link to share, start an instant meeting, or schedule in a Google Calendar. If you are having 100 students, then how can you send an email to everyone? No, you can just copy a link and go to your WhatsApp class, paste this link, and give the instruction to the student, and give a manually a time limit to the student and day that tomorrow there will be a class on 12:30. Please click the link. Or you can schedule a Google Calendar also. We are used to organize our class with scheduling a Google Calendar. What is a Google Calendar? Google Calendar is also a part of Gmail. As and when we click and schedule in Google Calendar, the page appears this. Yes, this the page appears this. Add title, your class, your conference, your meeting, whatever your concern is, add title, save. Timings are there. Their instruction, do not repeat, or one day before hour, or jo bhi aapko instruction deni hai. Join with Google Meet. There are so many instructions. You can follow it, whatever your need is. Again, scheduling a class. It's a simple teacher who is having a good laptop, good configuration of laptop or PC, and having an email account. Very easily, he or she can schedule his Google Meet or his class on his Google Meet. This is very, very easy instance. If you want to go broadcasting, you will use StreamYard. It is the most successful broadcasting nowadays. We are using it in StreamYard. What is this StreamYard? StreamYard is a live streaming studio in your browser. Interview guests, share your screen, and much more facilities are there. Stream directly to Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, and other platforms. As and when you log in your StreamYard, there you will find a code contact, you will find a link, you will find your dashboard, schedule your interview with the StreamYard. There are so many options. You can connect it with your Facebook, you connect with your YouTube, you connect with your LinkedIn sites. Try, it is amazing. It is new tool which less people are using. This is StreamYard. Now we are exploring our presentation softwares. What earlier we have done? We have done G Drive, facilities of G Drive, some facilities, not all. There are some facilities which are the concerns of a beginner or which are a beginner teacher or ordinary teacher. Then we have discussed some webinar tools. Any webinar tools is free of cost and paid. Whichever you will find, basically take an example. If you want to go to webinar, write it to you, go to webinar on your Google. He will give the instruction. These all digital tools are user friendly. You read these instructions, carefully adopt them, and you will successfully adopt your digital technologies. Next is your presentation software. What is this presentation software? It is a software package basically it has three functions. The most famous popular presentation software are these PowerPoint slides, Google slides, Prezi, Keynote slides. This can be used as a e-content also. Amazing feature of slide share is what? I humbly request to all teachers, please go to slide share. Why? I have made a PowerPoint slide और मुझे डर है कि वो खो जाएगी. वो कैसे खो जाएगी? कि वो चोरी हो जाएगी और उस पर कोई और नाम लिख के किसी और कॉलेज में उसे वो प्रेजेंट करेगा. So usually teachers are hesitant to give their PPTs to the students and the participants. Usually. No, I will not give up my PPTs. I will give only a one-page note to my lecture to you. No need to fear, sir, friends. Construct a beautiful PowerPoint with your own imagination, ideas, and innovation. As and when you have developed your PowerPoint, what will we do? We will open our SlideShare account. Go to Google, write a SlideShare. The page appears. Share and discover knowledge on linked SlideShare. Click the SlideShare. Friends, making an account on SlideShare, there will be a necessary requirement to have an account on LinkedIn Share. As and when we have our account on LinkedIn SlideShare, what will we find? This page appears. Yes, this page appears. Login with LinkedIn, login with Facebook. This is my account. I have account with the vbpunia at the readymail.com and I have given my password. Friends, ये वो password नहीं है जो हमारा personal mail का password है. Generally हमने क्या किया शुरू में पार्टी प्रेसिडेंट्स ने अपना आपका जो जीमेल आईडी है ये आप पासवर्ड है जो डायरेक्ट मेल पासवर्ड है हम लोग वो वाला पासवर्ड यहाँ लगाते हैं उसे नहीं लगाइएगा आप अपने पासवर्ड ये एक न्यू पासवर्ड दीजिएगा अपने सोशल मीडिया अकाउंट को मैंने एक न्यू पासवर्ड दिया है स्लाइडशेयर में अगेन द पेज अपीयर्स डिस्कवर शेयर लर्न हियर इज ऑन द अपर साइड लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ दिस स्लाइड there is a pop-up upload. I can upload my Microsoft PowerPoints, videos, and your PDFs, whatever I need, I can upload. As and when I will upload, click the upload, what will I find? I find upload a file. Yes. Upload a file. Now this is a space where can you upload your file. Select files to upload. Click the file. You can upload your file from Dropbox, from Google Drive, from Box, or from your Microsoft OneNote Drive. Upload your file on your SlideShare. After uploading share, this page appears. What this page wants from us? Title, description. You will write a description on this page. Category, I have written education. You can write it in your own category. Privacy. इसको मैंने first time भी privacy दिया है इसे public भी देंगे हम बाद में कि प्राइवेट हमने इसलिए दिया है ताकि अपलोड करते वक्त इसमें जो क्रिएटिव कॉमन लाइसेंस है या व्यू हम प्राइवेट के फॉर्म में देख सकें कि प्राइवेट फाइल के साथ हम जब कंफर्टेबल होंगे उसके बाद हम इसको वी विल गिव द इंस्ट्रक्शन टू गिव इट टू पब्लिक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल गिव द इंस्ट्रक्शन टू एज ए प्राइवेट पब्लिशिंग अब नाउ द फाइल इज इन पब्लिशिंग मोड इन ए प्राइवेट कंसर्न माय फाइल इज नाउ अपलोडेड इन ए प्राइवेट ये सिर्फ मैं देख सकती हूँ और कोई नहीं देख सकता इस फाइल को दिस इज अपलोडिंग इन ए प्राइवेट से देखिए नीचे क्या लिखा है इसी फाइल के नीचे एडिट प्राइवेसी सेटिंग एनालिटिक्स. उसके साथ साथ एनालिटिक्स के बाद यहाँ प्राइवेसी सेटिंग को करने के बाद प्राइवेसी सेटिंग के बाद क्या हो रहा है इसे प्राइवेसी सेटिंग में मैं प्राइवेसी सेटिंग दूंगी इसे एनालिटिक्स देंगे कि कितने लोगों मुझे पता चलेगा कि कितने लोगों ने इस स्लाइड को डाउनलोड किया है कितने लोगों ने इसे पसंद किया है कितने लोगों ने इस पर कमेंट किया है. ये सारा का सारा एनालिटिक्स फ्री में मेरे पास मौजूद होगा. इट विल बी अवेलेबल इन एनालिटिक्स फ्री. आई विल गिव द प्राइवेसी सेटिंग एंड आई ऑल्सो कैन एडिट दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. साइड बाई साइड डाउन स्ट्रीमिंग ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वट इज देयर इट यू आर सीइंग लाइसेंस. You are seeing license. What are the instruction of this slide here? You are seeing my topic, transforming class learning into virtual learning during lockdown and post COVID-19. 1923 views इसकी अब तक आ चुकी हैं. बहुत लोगों ने इसे देखा है. मुझे पता है 923 views हैं इसमें. Share और like में मैंने copy और इसमें हमें आप लोग इसको कर सकते हैं. Share भी कर सकते हैं, like भी कर सकते हैं. HRDC GJU हिसार के channel से मैंने इसे बनाया है. इसे देखिएगा लाइसेंस मिला है सीसी एट्रीब्यूशन नॉन कमर्शियल शेयर लाइक लाइसेंस. क्रिएटिव कॉमन लाइसेंस एक बिग कंसर्न है हमारे ई कंटेंट में. यू मस्ट नो अबाउट क्रिएटिव कॉमन लाइसेंस. इन स्लाइड शेयर यू कैन गिव योर लाइसेंस वट एवर यू लाइसेंस विल बी यू विल वॉन्ट टू यू वॉन्ट टू गिव योर कंटेंट चूज दैट क्रिएटिव लाइसेंस एंड देन गिव इट टू योर लाइसेंस. दिस इज योर स्लाइड. Amazing. So my humble request to all teachers, please go to SlideShare. If you are beginner in generating your e-content, no doubt we are habitual to develop our PowerPoint presentation. First, try to make an e-content through SlideShare. Amazing. आपको बहुत अच्छा लगेगा. मजा आएगा. ई कंटेंट डेवलप करने के बाद स्लाइड शेयर को डेवलप करने के बाद आप वीडियो डेवलप करेंगे, आप बुक्स डेवलप करेंगे, ई बुक्स, बहुत सारे कंटेंट ऑथरिंग, बहुत सारे टूल्स हैं इसमें. वास्ट, दिस इज द वास्ट वर्ल्ड ऑफ डिजिटल टूल्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. बट वी रिक्वेस्ट ऑल टीचर्स इन द बिगिनिंग यू मेक ए अकाउंट ऑन स्लाइड शेयर एंड एंजॉय आफ्टर सीइंग योर स्लाइड शेयर इन अ पब्लिक. This is presentation softwares. There are so many presentation software. Go to any of your choice and construct your digital context for this presentation software. Next is content creation tool. My slide is like switching. Yes, this is content creation tool. Content can be in any form. It can be PDF, it can be present PowerPoints, it can be images, it can be graphics, it can be social media, it can be blogging, etc. How can we generate our content? There is a big issue. You can create your content by using digital tools and techniques. Presenting a screenshot about Skinner Costumetry and Loom. When you have designed your LMS, when you have made your account on LMS, you have your PDFs, no doubt, in a lesson form. You have your slide here and PowerPoint presentation in a graphic sense. Now, what is remaining? It is remaining video. How can we make our video from our home? This is non-studio video. Videos are of two type, studio type and non-studio. Now my concern is with non-studio. I have not enough money. I have not enough time to go to a studio, shoot my video, edit my video. So what will I do? I will develop my video at my own computer sitting at home? How can? In Google, screenocastomatic. The page will appear this. Screenocastomatic screen and recorder and video editor is also applicable there. Click on screen recorder or screenocastomatic. It is free of cost. Teachers हैं हम लोग, मैं बहुत ही जनरल सी बात अपने देश अपने अपने भाषा वालों लोगों को बताया है हमने. फ्रेंड्स, हमने कभी बुक्स नहीं खरीदी, हमने हमेशा कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री बुक्स मिली हैं पढ़ने के लिए. सेम इज द केस विद डिजिटल टूल ऑल्सो. देर आर सो मेनी डिजिटल टूल्स. एज अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री कॉपी फॉर टीचर्स यू कैन गो फॉर फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. इफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल इन फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट देन गो टू योर पेड वर्जन. डेफिनेटली पेड वर्जन हैज सो मेनी फैसिलिटीज एज कम्पेयर टू योर फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. बट दिस इज फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. क्लिक इट स्किनोकस्टोमेटिक. द पेज अपियर्स. व्हाट द पेज अपियर्स? Please appear this video creation for everyone. Video creation for everyone. Start recording for free. Click on start recording for free. Or you can try our e-video editor. Try our video editor first. जब हम वीडियो शूट करते हैं तो जस्ट हम वीडियो शूट करते हैं, जस्ट वीडियो. मैं अपना वीडियो अभी आपको रॉ वीडियो अभी दिखाऊंगी. मैंने जो वीडियो लूम से बनाया है, स्किनोकास्टोमेटिक से बनाया है, दिस इज रॉ वीडियो. आफ्टर एडिटिंग द वीडियो और आफ्टर फॉर एडिटिंग द वीडियो वी कैन टेक हेल्प अवर वीडियो एडिटर. मैं चाहती हूँ कि मेरे वीडियो से पहले मेरी यूनिवर्सिटी की का एम्बलम हो और मेरे टॉपिक का नाम हो, फिर मेरा वीडियो हो, उसके बाद फिर से एक स्लाइड हो, फिर से इसके बाद एक स्लाइड हो. तो वी कैन टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम वीडियो एडिटर आल्सो. दिस इज आल्सो फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. एज एंड व्हेन वी स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग फॉर फ्री व्हाट अपीयर्स अगेन माय नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. यस, दिस इज स्किनोकास्टोमेटिक. वेलकम बैक. You have, I have my account, but you will create your account with sign in with Google and continue. This is your dashboard. I have made my video. I will share my video with you. This is video recording. Exactly, I will share. I'm switching my presentation to my screen. Okay.
Ma'am, your voice is lost somewhere.
I'm not comfortable in seeing my video, watching my video, so I'm cancel it.
Okay, it's okay. Yeah, even we have to just compile the session.
Yeah,
and,
yes, sir. Yes.
Going
yes.
Very amazingly. Yeah.
I think there is some problem in this screen sharing. I do. क्या हुआ इसके साथ?
It's okay. It's okay. Ma'am.
ऑर्गेनाइजर बनाया वैसे क्या मुझे ऑर्गेनाइजर से रहा
हूं. दैट्स व्हाई यू कुड शेयर द स्क्रीन मैम. यू आर वेरी मच ऑर्गेनाइजर. या
ओके ओके सर. आई एम शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन सर. आई एम शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन.
नो इशू मैम. नो इशू.
या यस सर. दिस इज I want to present my video also, but it could not be possible due to some technical glitches. So I'm again exploring my presentation. This is skin customatic. This is your my skin shot, skinocostometry. You can have Loom also. Please write Google Google screen Loom, and you have your I don't know what happened, why my screen is not allowing me to switch on. Yes. Sir, this
Vandana ji, namaste. Aap aise kijiye
pehle. Visible sir, it is visible screen of customatic.
Yes, it is visible.
After clicking the screen of customatic, you will find screen of customatic. I have solo plan, I have a team plan, and launch free recorder. Click on launch free recorder.
नहीं वो आपको इसलिए हो रहा है अभी आप अपना पीपीटी मोड में हैं आप एक बार स्क्रीन शेयरिंग स्टॉप करके दोबारा से स्क्रीन सिलेक्ट कर लीजिए इसी में नहीं आएगा
अच्छा ओके नहीं सर ठीक अच्छा सर ठीक है सर वापस इसको मैं लेके जाऊं ठीक है सर
जी अब पहले
सर दिस इज विजिबल नहीं सर ये विजिबल है स्क्रीन ऑफ कस्टमेटिक
हां वो अभी छोटे वाला विंडो है
अच्छा ठीक है सर ठीक है
इसमें जो तीसरा ऑप्शन है लंच फ्री रिकॉर्डर वो क्लिक करके देखिए
नहीं सर दिस इज स्क्रीनशॉट सर दिस इज स्क्रीनशॉट नॉट हैंड्स ऑन सेशन
ठीक है
दिस इज अ स्क्रीनशॉट दिस इज ओनली स्क्रीनशॉट यू विल लॉन्च फ्री रिकॉर्डर व्हाट हैपेंड Again, I am switching my next slide. Yes, sir, this is visible. My photo is visible to
yes,
all.
Yes, it's yeah. visible.
Yes, this is screenshot. Often when I had clicked on launch video, this is again screenshot. My video is there. I can take screenshot also of whole my screen. And also with webcam and both. Then I have made my video. This is video creation tool, skinocostometic. You can take skinocostometic, you can take skinocastify, and you can take Loom also. I have enjoyed developing my video with skinocostometic and Loom with NoStudio. Again, third very important digital tool is digital assessment. This is again switching. This is the last digital statement, digital assessment tools. What are the digital assessment tools? These tools are used for presentation of evidence, for judging student achievement, managed through the medium of computer, digital technology, use of electronic system and software to assess and evaluate the progress of individual learners in educational system. A popular example of this. Forms are certainly Google Forms. Mostly teachers are using now Google Forms. I have used Padlet, Quizlet, Socrative, Pose, etc. These are user friendly. You just go on Padlet, click the Padlet word, write a word Padlet on your Google. The show page screen open up. Kindly look at the instructions. Follow the instructions. You will have your Padlet. These are four digital assessment tools. A basic concern is now many teachers are not familiar with the LMS. Exactly what is LMS? I have heard about Moodle, I have heard about Google Classrooms, Canvas, but exactly what is the concept of learning management system? What is an LMS? Unified Learning Management System through a classroom approach. Sir, this is a big concern. This is a big puzzle for all teachers, students, and parents. What this big puzzle is, I'm describing my word with some sort of illustration. A big concern about delivery of online. I'm surprised to see the surrounding where A is very curious about taking his class on virtual mode and searching the platform. B is engaging his class on Zoom, Google Meet, or other similar platforms. Students get totally confused when their teacher send a message to them install the particular app and tomorrow 6 a.m. there will be a class. Meantime, there is another message from other teacher. Download the app. which is different to the previous one. And tomorrow there will be a class and time will be announced shortly on these types of arrangements. It is clear to the pandemic. It is clear to the pandemic 19, online learning is now necessity, and necessity is not the mother of invention, but also is the innovation. Exactly what is now a unified learning management system. One must know about unified learning management system, and there are many types of learning management system. What is the concept of learning management system? What a teacher wants a learning management system should be. There should be announcement facility on my learning management system. I can easily announce my students whatever will be on Sunday, whatever will be on Monday, whatever will be, but the test will be scheduled on which date, which type of weblinks they should be accessed to. There should be announcement facility. These announcement facilities are Google Classroom, there will be Moodle. There are so many LMSs are there. There is an announcement facility. Then notes facility should be there. Document facility should be there. There should be multimedia gallery, learning track facility, links facility, reference facility, news facility, assignment facility, assessment facility, discussion forms, and live streaming. These are some learning management system, and we are working on pre-established LMSs. There are some type of Google Classroom, Moodle, LMS, Canvas. Mera concern, engineering teachers say, computer science teachers say, or sabse ye concern, why not we must have our own unified learning management system customized on our own need-based designs. Moodle is a foreign system. बहुत लोग उसको कंफ्यूज हो जाते हैं फर्स्ट टाइम देखते हैं कि व्हाट इज मूडल नो नो मैम दिस इज सो मच कॉम्प्लेक्स वी विल नॉट इन अ सिचुएशन टू ट्रैक द मूडल और टू लर्न द मूडल कैनवस इज आल्सो अ फॉरेन कॉन्सेप्ट ब्लैक बोर्ड इज आल्सो अ फॉरेन कॉन्सेप्ट मुझे लगता है क्यों नहीं हमारा अपना एक देशी कॉन्सेप्ट भी होना चाहिए जो कि बेस्ड हो जहां हमारे टीचर्स और स्टूडेंट्स दे आर बिगिनर टू दिस सिस्टम They are just started to this system. Why not our computer teachers will frame a unified learning management system, which will be suitable or adaptable to all our indigenous teachers? This is my request to all teachers. Sir, Dr. Mina said, I have taken some digital tools and technologies to explore my presentation. I have taken Google Drive facilities, some Google Drives. We can explore more facilities on Google Drive. We can explore more facilities on learning management system, and we can explore more facilities on presentation style. This is my submission, and this is my also a message to our system, our teachers, me also. Let welcome a strong move towards collaboration and new ways to teaching and learning with empowered faculty and enriched students to make them responsible and value-driven citizens to convert the challenges of COVID-19 into a big learning opportunity. This is my submission to all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am. It was an amazing, amazing talk, very informative. You started from A and you could brought to my all participants to even a Z level. They started from the Google document, the basic thing. It is the ABCD of this e-content generation and reaching till the video editing part, which is the most crucial part. Now, after this session, I believe my 130 participants, those are attending today this session and watching this video of the session afterwards, because this video is most important. In a one particular time which you have given, it's not sufficient. They have to watch your recorded video, I think, 3 times, 4 times to understand the concept, because it is there in your DNA. You explained in a such a nice way. I feel honored to be bringing you to this session, and it has been delivered in a very nice way. I have no words to give you my gratitude, my thanks to you. You attended well in time, and all the participants have enjoyed this. And I'm just going to be give us our appreciation, small appreciation in the form of a certificate of appreciation, which will read to you e-content way, like email through to you. So which I'm displaying over here on the behalf of the SLIT Longowal, on behalf of NIT Uttarakhand, I'm just going to be present the certificate of appreciation to you. Thank you. Thanks a lot. to you for coming and delivering. And I'll take up, because most of your work, I have done it. Your some questions were coming on the chat box, and you were, of course, you were on your presentation. So I was doing this job, you know, simultaneously. I answered many of the questions. So that's why I couldn't find, but still I request my other organizers, my colleague, if any significant question which I could not reply and you want to be raised, just one or two questions, just read out and just speak. So she's here to answer. Otherwise, our another speaker, eminent speaker, Dr. R.C. Sharma, is already there, and he's going to start without any break, without any delay, because his session is also going to be equally very significant, because he's a man from the, you know, world. He worked in different countries, in different universities of this world, and he's bringing OER, you know, OER in India, that is an open education resource. So before we will give a final gratitude to ma'am, if any question, yeah, please can read out my organizers. Yeah.
Sir, there is one question. Like, I also want to know that which software or app is best for shortening the size of videos. If we made a video that is 600 MB, what we have to upload up to 300 MB, that what we will do?
Then you can embed the video through R.C. Sharma is listening to me. He can give the answer, sir. We can synchronize the file, and we can embed the file, video file, according to the space.
Okay, perhaps let me share my screen and then and go there. Actually, friends, you may be seeing my screen now. When I was listening to Vandana ji, there is an opportunity for you. Let me type that name into the chat box. There is a good opportunity for you. Only, I think today is 25th. So you have got 4 days only. This is a good video editing software, ACDC Video Studio 3. If you know about Camtasia, which is a proprietary software, number one in terms of video editing, but for that you need to pay. The company, it has made it free to download until 29th of July. So I suggest that you all just go to this website and download this. Not only that, along with it, here you will see the various products. So just to shorten your video from one format or its size, you can use Format Factory. So this Format Factory, it will allow you to convert, or even, you know, personally, the software which I use, it is VSDC, Video Editor. This one. So you can try this. They are wonderful softwares. Means, but you know, they can do many things, including chroma key effect and all those. And here you can see the video converter is there, audio converter is there. The video editor is there. So, and these are free downloads and not heavy files, around 40 MB, something like that. Yes, Prerana ji, the things which I have told you are free, except this one, ACDC, which the company has given you up till 29th of July to download it free. And it is a full-fledged package. You just need to, you know, put your email ID here, and then it will send you the key. The access key, those I think it is around 20 letters, the key, the password for that, which you need to use it to register it there.
Okay, that's thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It is really amazing. Even it was a discovery for me as well. Although I used to be very much savvy in these kind of things, being, you know, that connected with the e-learning from last 4 to 5 years. But it was a new discovery. Thanks a lot. Immediately after your session at the lunchtime, I am going to be download. I think many of my participants are also going to be download after your session. So thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Vandana Punia.
Sir, Monkey, sir, Manbir sir, I have a question. I have a small question which I am eagerly for asking. Okay. If you kindly allow me.
I'll allow you, but otherwise nobody is allowed to come on a mic and do this because the session is very limited timing. Yeah, please. Okay, only one question.
Okay. Just 1 minute. Thank you for allowing me to ask the question. Thank you, Punya Madam, for your amazing presentation and informative to all of us. Now, actually, I am Professor Sarkar from GIS Group, Kolkata. I used to take the live classes to my students in Google Meet and uploading the lectures in Google Classroom. That we used to follow in my GIS Group in Kolkata. Now, in Google Meet, while sharing the video to the students, but we face a problem that the students can see the video, but not the audio is not audible to them. So that problem we are facing in Google Meet, since you have referred the instrument, the Google Meet, one of the live class tool in the online classes. So what is the solution of that? Because students can watch the video, but that cannot, they cannot hear the sound. So if you kindly give the solution of that, please.
Dr. Vandana, if you allow me to be speak on this, may I speak?
Yes, sir.
Ah, thank you. Yeah, I read your this query even on the chat box. I didn't want to be reply. I'll tell you, this must be a technical problem with your gadget or device. If you say I can go now to Google Meet immediately from my this screen sharing and I will speak, because I'm continuously taking classes on a Google Meet without any hurdle, without any glitches, audio as well as video. Only the issue, I'll tell you.
I'm not telling that. I can take the live class in Google Meet. Student can. I am audible to the students. That I am not asking. My question is very specific. Suppose there is an Amitabh Bachchan talk of motivation speech. So while starting the very beginning the classes, very beginning of the classes, I used to run the video of Amitabh of some motivational classes. Now they can watch the video, but they cannot listen the audio talk of that video which I am sharing my screen. But they can hear my talk. So that technical problem I am facing, that we all, rather I would say the all. So that I do not know what would be the solution.
Does mean that on a Google Meet, you want to play some video on your screen and you want to make that your video to be go and play with the same. No, sir, it is not. You want to bring a Film City free of cost at your home. No, it is not possible. It is not possible. Today morning, if you joined in time, have you heard the music? I have given a background music. I have given a PPT. Everything was very much clear to all of you. I think most of the participants can write on a chat box. Sir, the problem is that even today, when ma'am, she was trying to be play a video, there is a proper link. When you are going to be play a video, they will disconnect you from your outer world and your video will be definitely going to be broadcast. Of course, that needs some technical things, which I cannot take it over here, but it is very much feasible. I will request someone in GIS only, maybe Kavya or someone, those are very much prominent on this kind of things, Sila or Randa, sir, they can help you out and we will do it.
In that case, instead of selecting the application window, if you try to select entire window, means entire screen, but sometimes what happens that if you select a particular application, there are two options. You select entire screen or application. The application part sometimes, the only difficulty, if you means be careful, when you select entire screen and if there are many things on your screen, on your desktop, anytime whenever you switch something, those things will be visible.
We always used to take the window, not the inter screen, and same problem we are not facing in Zoom video, Zoom Live or the BlueJeans or the GoToMeeting. But only thing this problem I am facing in Google Meet. That's why I'm telling to share. Actually, if you can. Okay. Anyway, you have confirmed me.
So Google Meet have some technical issue or maybe sometime device. But I think it's something new. Thank you for your concern, and it has been taken well. And we will even reply you through email also. I will do some troubleshooting and I will check it out. So now I request our Dr. Mahiraj, my colleague, my friend, head of the Department of Electrical Engineering, NIT Uttarakhand, to please give a welcome to our next speaker, Professor R.C. Sharma ji, for his session. Please, Dr. Mahiraj.
A very good afternoon to all. And it's a great pleasure for me to introduce Dr. Ramesh Chandra Sharma, Professor Ambedkar University. Dr. Ramesh Chandra Sharma is an associate professor at Ambedkar University. He has a broad area of expertise in topics like e-learning, instructional design, open educational resources, open and distance learning, teacher education, educational technology, and educational research. Dr. Ramesh also holds a PhD in educational technology. He has published many articles based on distance learning and online methods of teaching. He also has a history of teaching at renowned national and international institutions across the world. Some of them include Wasam Open University, Malaysia, University Brazil, University of Fiji, and Indira Gandhi National Open University, India, Choturam College of Education, Haryana, and other colleges also in India. Now I want to give the online platform to Professor Ramesh Chand Sharma to share his views and
Welcome, sir. Now it's your show. Please.
I was muted. So thank you Mahirajji, and thank you Dr. This is a very interesting topic of OER, but I think that sometimes we don't get the opportunity to learn related things. So I have modified my presentation a bit, and before we go into the actual field of OER, I'm thinking that we can see somehow some of the things which are related to that in this field, because of we as a teacher, as a researcher, and as a learner, we have to deal with many things which are related to it. So first of the thing which we should be aware of are some of the related terms and areas in which we work. So perhaps you may be aware that in India we do have a national IPR policy, which was accepted and approved by the cabinet in 2015, around 5 years ago. This the basic purpose of this IPR national policy is to protect our intellectual property. The reason being is that had we not been strict and aware about our own things, वो आप लोगों को बड़ी मुश्किल होने वाली थी कि नीम हमारा नहीं रहता, अनाज हमारा नहीं रहता, ढेर सारी चीजें, इवन हल्दी के ऊपर भी कुछ बाहर के भाई लोगों की निगाह थी, दैट ट्राई टू पेटेंट दोस थिंग्स. इट इज द क्रेडिट टू आवर गवर्नमेंट एंड सम अवेयर पीपल हु वर चेकिंग, एंड पर्टिकुलरली आफ्टर दैट WTO एंड दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स इन द इंडस्ट्री साइड, इन द बिजनेस वर्ल्ड, थिंग्स वर मूविंग इन अ वेरी शॉडी एंड शेडी मैनर. So then the governments, the related departments, they had to act fast and protect. Otherwise, few of our indigenous technologies, our indigenous products, even the yoga, means I don't know why the people call it yoga. It is yoga actually. So, but maybe the English word is more popular there. It originated with us. But the claim is being taken by Western countries only. They are more popular than our own Babaji, Baba Ramdev, like that. So that way, these things, they become very much important. It has certain objectives, the purpose which it serves for us, that what is the benefit of we should be, how we can extend the outreach and promote our IPRs to save them. So that and because it is based on our various kind of interests, which can be social, which can be cultural, which can be economic, something like that. And then the kind of knowledge is generated in our institutions to protect it from being misused by others. There are various things we will see very soon, which come into that way. So that nobody, and particularly nowadays, you maybe might have already noted it, that the hackers around the world, and particularly they are believed to be the Russian hackers this time. I don't know why the Chinese hackers, they were not publicized for that act. It is believed that they are trying to steal, they are trying to hack the networks to find the cure for COVID-19, the coronavirus, because various laboratories around the world, various scientists around the world, they are seriously working on that. And you know, it is networked world. So the things they are happening, that the hackers nowadays, I mean, just it is a very recent news that they are trying to steal the formula if somebody has developed it, because the news are coming up, including in India also, that we are in a much better position, in a advanced stage of creating a medicine for this virus, like that. So we should be vigilant, we should be careful about it, that nobody takes it. But if something goes wrong in some way, still if something happens, what are the legal and legislative frameworks available to protect that person? Either it is the interest of an individual which is getting affected, or the interest of an institution which is getting affected from there, to protect it, to provide them the legal mechanisms to safeguard their interest and safeguard our own knowledge. And that is the purpose. But to reach to that stage, we need to know that what are various administrative steps to follow. If we need to protect something, how to protect it? If something has gone wrong, what should be done? To whom we need to approach? How the application is filed? How the process is to be taken further? Those kind of things. We need to be aware of those things. And then once it is, something comes up, there is a triangle of, we have the creators who create the things, the innovators who take the lead into it, and the users. Triangle, the three-party connections there, to allow them to make a better use of their knowledge, their product, their content in some what way, and to take it to the next level, to mass level or to a commercial level, to develop something there. You may be knowing that in India we have a famous, and particularly perhaps I'm not sure, but maybe the credit goes to Punjab, maybe it originated from there. You must have heard that term called as Jugaad. So we are very much, in fact, long back when I was a regional director of IGNU in Karnal, and we had a center in Ambala, there was this person, he was trying to find out a solution of having something related to some equipment, and he tried, many people try to get it, rectified, repaired. He failed. Ultimately, he went to Ambala. There he found certain, our local engineers, and they, within no time, they repaired that machine. So due to some jugaad, like in the older days, if you know that we had Bajaj Chetak and perhaps LML, what was the name of that scooter? I forgot. It was some LML company. So if you, and the Bajaj Chetak parts, they were like so much of the fitting, that if that scooter gets something, uska pech leke usme laga dijiye, chalega, daudega, no problem, like that. But to take it to the commercial level there, and there are various organizations, we have Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council, we have NRDC, we have TFAC there, how they play their role in getting these things together and in a better way, so that our industries are supported. Nowadays, our government is serious about Atmanirbhar, so that we don't depend on others for our products. How that can be? When we support our own industries, our own labs, and the products which they create from them, we can promote them. Otherwise, wahi hota hai. For a user, they need to get the product which is available to them easily. At that time, we don't think, oh, abhi toh theek hai ke, that we are boycotting Chinese products. Otherwise, just last year tak hi, wo jo aapne Diwali pe jo ladi khareedne, wo Chinese wali hi sabke ghar mein aa rahi thi. Even Lakshmi, Ganesh, etc., they were coming from China. So those things, they are very important for us. And then the process of enforcing the rules, or in some cases, how that adjudication will be taken further in case of protecting the law, how to implement them, keeping them in force there, the various knowledge about it. And ultimately means to develop the human power, the human capital investment, the development of human labor force in this area. And that's why, you know, although at present this field is mostly available in other national law universities courses or law courses or something, but I believe that since like research is an inherent part of all the educational programs, maybe if somebody is doing a MA in education or MEd or something there, or as a part of MPhil, those things they come up. But I believe that these should, like the environmental sciences, UGC proposed that it be a compulsory course at all the levels, which I certificate level ka hi kyun na ho, chota sa. But normally we don't make ourselves aware even at the institutional level. This is very significant, very important about it. So once we are aware of it, there are various kind of terms which we should be aware of. What are those terms? Like patent, you must have heard about it, and you will be happy that I have also got one in my name. I have pasted the photo of here. This is my team in Brazil. वो भी मैं पाल जी जब मेरा जी मेरा सीवी पढ़ रहे थे, दैट इज द बाहिया स्टेट नेशनल बाहिया स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी. बाहिया इज द सेकंड बिगेस्ट स्टेट इन ब्राजील आफ्टर साम पालो, एंड देयर वी हैव अवर टीम विच वी वर वर्किंग ऑन वर्चुअल म्यूजियम्स एंड रोल प्लेइंग गेम्स. यू मस्ट हैव सीन दोज कंप्यूटर गेम्स इन विच यू अज्यूम द रोल ऑफ समथिंग एंड देन दे आर ऑफ वेरियस काइंड. The most famous are those you go and keep shooting all those evil creatures from there, something like that. So those kind of things, try to patent your process or your product so that you can it cannot be misused by others. In academia we are more concerned with copyright. You generate a knowledge and then you try to protect it. Why? Otherwise the people, and maybe I will show you that slide very soon. You have an idea and somebody steals it. And this is very interesting. Perhaps you may be knowing that in the older times, when the scientists, they are working on a theory, on some equation or some product or some invention or something, you know what they used to do? They used to write a letter to themselves. So you write a letter and it goes to the post office, comes back to you. You write a letter to yourself. And in that case, suppose me and Manna ji, we have thought of something, aur kal ko hum dono mein aapas mein ladai ho jaye, Punjab Haryana Chandigarh court mein hum dono pahunch jaye ki ji ye to mera product tha, inhone chura liya. At that time we need some sort of proof with us. So they used to do that in those times, and to have an evidence that look, at this time I had created this, developed this, so it belongs to me, like that. Aur aajkal to bahut easy ho gaya hai. What people are doing nowadays, they just send an email to themselves, and the better part here is the email, that it has a time stamp into it which goes up to milliseconds. So yadi mere aur Manna ji ne same cheez pe kaam kiya 12:00 pe, to jaise hi hamari mail chalegi usme wo milli microsecond tak ka hum time dhoond sakte hain ki pehla kaun tha, like that. But this is very important to protect the copyright, because it involves the interest of the parties related to it. And means they, everybody would like to protect their own thing. But isi ki wajah se hum OER pe pahunchenge, kyunki there were some issues related to that. The other thing is the service marks or the trademarks, to register them. Aur ye iska ek bada example aapko milega, khaskar particularly wo jo title ke ko lekar hota hai, the very famous in our own Bollywood. Aajkal Bollywood waise hi badi charcha mein hai, due to various reasons, but sometimes there is a tendency of the people to register a name of a movie, wo chahe us pe banaye bilkul na, but wo title register karke rakh lega, that then somebody who wants to make that movie, if nobody wants to make movie, farak kya padta hai, register kara ke rakh liya. If somebody wants to make movie, they will come to you and will request you ki bhai sahab ye title mere ko de do, kyunki main iske upar movie bana. And that's why sometimes the things changes. राम गोपाल वर्मा जब शोले के ऊपर मूवी बनाना चाह रहे थे तो सिप्पी परिवार ने बड़ा ऑब्जेक्शन किया, तो उनको नेम चेंज करना पड़ा और वो पता नहीं शोले की आग और समथिंग और वो बुरी तरह से पिट नहीं था उसने, दैट फेल्ड। बट दैट इज अ रियल चैलेंज देयर। एंड आपने इसका एक एग्जाम्पल और देखा होगा, आप में से जो लोग यूज टू ट्रेवल इन द बस लॉन्ग एगो, नाउअडेज नोबडी ट्रेवल्स इन द बस बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजंस, बट क्या होता था, एज सून एज द बस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बस स्टेशन और बस स्टैंड, समबडी विल यू नो एंटर द बस, एक झोला होगा जिसके अंदर 10 रुपए में 5 कंघे या ये कोलगेट ले लीजिए, एंड सम पीपल दे विल बाय इट थिंकिंग दैट ओ कोलगेट मिल रही है इतने सस्ते में, बट इफ यू रीड इट वेरी केयरफुली द स्पेलिंग मे बी COLFATE, मींस इट मे बी और KOL, दे विल यूज द कलर द फॉन्ट साइज एवरीथिंग सेम, विल मेक ए माइनर चेंज समवेयर टू डिसीव टू मेक ए काउंटरफिट प्रोडक्ट। और आप लोगों ने नॉर्थ इंडिया में तो काफी मींस विंटर्स में बड़ा होता है, कस्टम्स डिपार्टमेंट्स हैव मेनी टाइम सीज्ड the I think that is borolin cream and its fake products, anything which gets popular, manna ji bade popular hain to manna ji ke duplicate aa jayenge market ke andar to take the benefit of that, to protect those things we we try to you know protect them there. Then another thing is industrial design. You see, either on the basis of the nature of the material or the design of the material or the comfort which it provides to you. Abhi main janta hu kuch log to palang pe lete hue honge is session ko dekhne ke liye, but those who are sitting on a chair, you will find that you and you must have seen many kind of chair, although chair ka purpose ek hi hai ki aapne uske upar baithna hai, but why the industrial design is more famous, to make your product unique from others. And whether it is you know there is a term called as ergonomics, और आप में से जो कंप्यूटर को ज्यादा डील करते होंगे उनको ये ज्यादा अच्छा पता होगा, क्योंकि लॉन्ग टाइम तक माउस को और कीबोर्ड पे टाइप करने से ये जो कार्पल जो हमारा सिंड्रोम है, ये यू नो इट गेट्स स्टार्टिंग हर्ट फ्रॉम देयर, टू प्रोटेक्ट इट, टू मेक ए बेटर डिजाइन फॉर इजी यूज, एर्गोनॉमिक्स टू मेक अवर ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड पर्टिकुलरली द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट। और इसीलिए आप देखेंगे कि जो ऑफिस चेयर्स होती हैं, आप एक बार दुकान पे चले जाएं कि मुझे ऑफिस चेयर चाहिए, वो आपको इतने सारे डिजाइन देगा, हर एक की इतनी क्वालिटीज बताएगा, दैट इट बिकम्स अ डिफिकल्ट डिसीजन टू सेलेक्ट व्हाट शुड वी गो। देन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द मटेरियल, नील कमल कुर्सी फेमस हो गई थी एक बार ड्यू टू इट्स डिजाइन एंड वाइट, तो वो जो शादी ब्याह में या जो बाहर रखते हैं कभी भी खराब नहीं होगी, दिस दैट एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, दैट बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट गिव्स अ यूनिक आइडेंटिटी टू योर प्रोडक्ट। सिमिलरली to the software design, let's say this screen which I am showing you right now, it is a screen of my latest MOOC, and you will feel happy that one of our own colleague Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha, who is the principal at GHG College in Ludhiana perhaps, he was my student. There and there were 4861 registered students into it. So the software platforms, we use this platform MOOKit by IIT Kanpur, you have Microsoft Word, so many softwares, in softwares you protect it so that it should not be misused, but although due to the piracy, I think that is the film industry and the software industry, they are the biggest sufferers of piracy, illicit downloads and those kind of things, heavy loss. The people, they invest millions and millions of money into develop it, and once it is released, wo shayad aapko yaad hoga X-Men movie mein wo jo last wala unka aaya tha, before it got released, means it was to release, it got leaked into it, even uska final end tak pura edit bhi nahi hua tha, and the people watched it. Once you watch it, who is going to watch into it into the cinema halls? That issue. Another thing is the business models. Various industries, various houses, they have their a specialist kind of a business model, and that makes them different. That makes them either more you know successful than others, or have some sort of a unique identity with them. So your what is your business model for that? Say like something, we have our own teaching philosophy. Every person, every one of us, when we teach in our own unique way, and that's why you know, one of my student, she is also from Punjab. One day she was telling me that unki beti ko mathematics pasand nahi hai. I thought that maybe one of the reason maybe that she doesn't like her teacher of mathematics due to some reason. That's why, because if you like your teacher, whatever the subject may be, you may going to like it. So it depends on the methodology, the behavior, the empathy, those things there. What model are we using in education? It is our education model, our teaching model, our learning model, theories of learning, so many things. What fits where? How do we use them in a particular way? There are certain other terms of the similar area which we use, like first party, the originator of that, the holds the first thing. And this first party and the second party, they are around the same thing because they belong to the institution from there. But then you must have heard this name third party. Third party is that which takes the advantage of that, not directly involved into it, but and aap logon ne usko zyadatar jo hum third party kehte hain, so you must have heard that the third party insurance, you know, for your vehicle you need to get it done, or life insurance or health insurance or something. Then you, because third party, it becomes cheaper if you go, if you purchase a, you know, say you are buying a car. First time when you buy the car, you get it from the first party, the company which gives it to you. It is a different matter, the company may have tie up with some other Assurance India or LIC or whatever, or whatever, that is a different matter, but you are getting it from them directly from there. That's why it is expensive. After 2-3 years, once that term is over and you are free to go anywhere, then we try to go to Policy Bazaar or something which gives us in a much lower economic or the costing package to us. So those, they take it. Then we have the term called as inventors. It can be either as a group, so the team led by, but even if it is a team, then somebody will become the lead inventor. Like Manaji, he is such an expert on online education and MOOCs, etc. And if he creates a software, he creates a philosophy, he creates a process. I believe that he was very much instrumental in that four quadrant model of into it. And when we cite it, we give the credit to him. So he becomes the lead inventor, like something like principal inventor, or the principal investigator in case of a research from there. But when that happens, we need to be aware of NDA, non-disclosure agreement. And particularly it becomes very important when we are holding an important position, say like in the ministries or in the defense or something there, the people are supposed to take an oath that even when I will not be in my office, in my this capacity, still I cannot reveal or disclose the sensitive information that may be in the national interest or something in business also. Isiliye aapne dekha hoga ki business ke andar poaching, POACHING, business poaching, wo bhi bahut hota hai. Log aapko baar baar phone karenge, coca cola wala pepsi wale ko phone karega ki ji mere yahan aa jao, aapko 1 crore usse zyada dunga. And there have been cases where people have found to be jumping, you know, 2 saal is company mein kaam kiya, knowledge liya, choda usko, dusri jagah pe chale gaye, and like that it happened. That is called as the business poaching there. But definitely nobody would like ki aap kisi ko train kare aur wo fir aapko 2 saal ke baad bye bye satrikal manna ji, I'm going and I'm joining Delhi University, like that. But it happens. There are the things. Then the important term here, another, is called as the licensing. And when particularly when you purchase a software, अभी मैंने आपको जो ACDC का जो वो दिखाया था, that making it free, so you can download it. That will be legal. Nobody is going to, you know, chase you. But otherwise, you need to purchase the license for a particular software. And that licensing, similarly of a product, say in this example, you see the Coca-Cola. It is from a different store. So we licensing Maruti Suzuki. So the technology is created by Suzuki, licensed to Maruti, that Maruti will make these things, and then the product will be launched from here. That kind of licensing. So you have certain sort of an agreement among various parties, where which the originator, the holder of that, gives the license to other party to use it, something like that. There, and then we have a term called as conflict of interest. आप में से जो लोग रिसर्च आर्टिकल लिखते होंगे उनको ये मालूम होगा, और पर्टिकुलरली जो पेपर रिव्यू करते हैं, दैट if an editor has requested you to review a paper, definitely most of the times they will ask you that please declare that whether you have any conflict of interest or potential conflict of interest with this paper or not. वो क्या होता है suppose, और नॉर्मली तो आजकल जर्नल्स जो है वो उसको एनोनिमस बनाने की बोलते हैं. When you submit it, they will ask the authors that please remove your all identity. But uske bawajood bhi, on the basis of my own experience, I am the editor of Asian Journal of Distance Education for the past 17 years. By reading and by knowing my own colleagues in my area, I know that who writes what and in what style. So if a paper comes to me, there may be chances that even if they remove their authorship from there, or even the self-citation from the references, still you can find out that this person may be the author. And then this conflict of interest may come. If that person is your friend, you will go a different way. और वो जानी दुश्मन है तो आप बस नहीं जाने दोगे. That way, the conflict of there. This brings us to these things of open educational resources. What happened? That due to the challenges of copyright issues, there as a teacher, as a researcher, as a learner, we need to have the access to the content material. अभी क्या हो गया कि पैसे किसी के पास नहीं है, ना तो टीचर तो खरीद ही नहीं सकता. आपके पास 60 स्टूडेंट है क्लास में, आई डोंट थिंक दैट और एवरी ईयर वो तो चेंज हो जाना है. यू कांट कीप ऑन परचेजिंग बुक्स फॉर देम. सो व्हाट टू डू, यू आस्क द लाइब्रेरी. लाइब्रेरी से क्या करें सर, फंड नहीं है हमारे पास, हम कहाँ से इतनी किताब खरीदेंगे. स्टूडेंट से बोलोगे खुद खरीद लो, वो कहेगा फीस ही देने के पैसे नहीं है हमारे पास, बुक्स कहाँ से खरीदे. बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉपीराइट नॉलेज होल्डर पाई एंड इन दैट केस देन द नीड फॉर अल्टरनेटिव लाइसेंसेज एंड ओपन एक्सेस केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस वेयर. और पर्टिकुलरली मैंने इसका बैकग्राउंड पढ़ा था, मैं आई एम श्योर दैट दैट इज करेक्ट बिकॉज आई रेड इट समवेयर. That how it originated. There is this person, and his wife was, going to the hospital for delivery, and there was some complication into it. So he wanted to, although the doctors were taking care of his wife, but he wanted to learn more about the complication. You know, people they have self-interest in learning themselves to make them more aware about that. ये क्या चीज़ है ये? And wherever he wanted to search something. Either it is asking for the subscription or pay or something not able to see. Or institutional mein bolega, login karo, tab isko padhna. And that time, the movement was started that can we make some of the knowledge as open access knowledge. And to go for that, this is for you also. It is a good resource to see the directory of open access journals. And many of these are here in UGC care list also. Although I don't want to discuss UGC care list due to various other parameters into it. Maybe some of you are also not happy with what is there in that list, but anyway, this is a good resource of checking because here all the articles, they are openly accessible to you. And in many of the journals, if you want to publish your own research, they may be free. There will be no APC, article processing charges or something into it. And along with, and particularly to me, I believe, प्रोफेसर मन्ना में करेक्ट में इसका क्रेडिट बिल गेट्स को और उसकी कंपनी को जाता है. माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वाज डोमिनेटिंग टू सच एन एंड इट स्टिल डोमिनेट्स, देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन अबाउट इट. ऑफ द अबाउट आई थिंक 95-97% ऑफ द वर्ल्ड मशीन्स दे रन ऑन एंड पर्टिकुलरली द पीसी सेगमेंट, नॉट द सर्वर सेगमेंट्स, ऑल्दो आईआईएस इज ऑल्सो देयर द प्रोप्राइटरी सॉफ्टवेयर एंड देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन इट. At least he started his industry, and that's why this is their business model. But then piracy, starting those things. So a group, a movement of open source software started. अभी वंदना जी ने आपको Moodle का वो नाम दिया था. There are, you have the if you are using Firefox, Open Office. If you don't want to use, go for Microsoft Office. You can download this Open Office. You have Fedora. You have Blender, which is a open source 3D animation software, PHP, on which the LAAMP, Moodle is based on LAAMP, Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP. That is the model for that. You have Java. So many things are there. For these things, for in education or in our normal life, we must thank this gentleman. Any idea who is this? Manna ji nahi bolenge, unko pata hai ye kaun hai. So if you can quickly type the name in the chat box that who is this person, then great. Otherwise make a guess that who is this. And those of you, even you know him or don't know him, you can silently thank this person. इनकी वजह से आज हमारी लाइफ में कितना आराम है. वो कैसे आराम है? आप लोग यदि टिकट खरीदना चाहते हो रेलवे का, मुझे नहीं लगता आप रेलवे स्टेशन जाते हो कि चलो अमृतसर रेलवे स्टेशन पे जाना है. यू डू इट योर यूजिंग नो वे. यू डू टू पे योर बिजली बिल. यू डोंट गो टू द बिजली बोर्ड ऑफिस टू पे योर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल और समथिंग. इवन घर में भी आजकल थिंग्स दे कम इट. ही इज सर टिम बर्नर्स-ली. And he is the creator of World Wide Web. Around 30 years ago, he created and he never patented his invention. Similarly, let me give you another example of Elon Musk. Yeah, the SpaceX wala banda, Elon Musk. He created the electric car framework, and later on, I think just 4-5 years ago, he made the patent of his electric car as the open patents. He made them available as open source. Because he says that this is a real problem of global warming, and we need zero pollution for that. The electric cars, they are zero pollution cars, but I cannot make the cars for whole of the world. If anybody can take, and similarly the Volvo company, you know, jab hum aap car mein baithte ho to aap seat belt bandhte ho. The three pin safety pin was created by Volvo company, and they also released their patents. That's why the other automobile they could use that. Because it is related to the life saving, it is a life saving device. That's why there are certain things. Now, this is the famous case of Delhi University and publishers and photocopiers, which went up to the court because everybody was having some problem with that. The students, they were saying that aap hame padha rahe ho, padhne ke liye koi kitab to de do. Teacher se poochte hain, teacher ke main kahan se laun, mere paas ek hi book hai. Library jao, library mein pahuncho, kahenge ji hamare paas 5 copies hain, baant lo aapas mein. How can 30 students buy 5 copies with that? They aur khareed lo, kahan se khareed lo? There is no funds. So what is Dhadalle se being doing? That take this book, go to that photocopy shop, get it photocopied, or baant lo aapas mein. But it was hurting the interest. And there, I mean, it's a very, very long, kai saalon tak chala, ultimately kuch decision hua uske andar. But there is a solution to that problem. The solution is open licenses. What are these open licenses? There are many kind of open licenses. Software industry mein aap log jo hoge aap jante honge, jab hum open inki baat karte to GNU like Linux or Unix or those things hoti hain, they come into there. Or BSD, Berkeley State, they also issue license. Similarly, in here in education for us, we go for Creative Commons licenses, CC license. Kahin pe aapko ye gole ke andar CC likhai dikhai dega. You can understand that this is an open license. It is a sort of a non-profit organization in United States which offered certain 6 kind of licenses. Aapko kahin bhi kisi bhi kitab ke upar, article ke upar, website ke upar, blog ke upar, video ke upar, kahin pe bhi ye aise nishan dikhe, to iska kya matlab hai ki aap is material ko bina permission mange use kar sakte ho. Because in here the permission is already given. यदि मन्ना साहब ने एक आर्टिकल लिखा आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस के ऊपर और उन्होंने उसको किसी भी इनमें से किसी भी एक सीसी लगा के रिलीज कर दिया, सो यू डोंट नीड टू कॉल हिम कि सर तुसी तुहाडा आर्टिकल यूज करना सी परमिशन दे रहे हो. नो नीड. परमिशन ही हैज ऑलरेडी ग्रांटेड इट इन कॉपीराइट. इफ यू वांट टू यूज इट यू नीड टू ऑब्टेन द परमिशन. सो वन स्टेप एंड दैट इज अ वेरी बिग स्टेप. कॉपीराइट के अंदर वो आपसे बोलेगा कि जी खरीद लो, मैं नहीं दे सकता आपको. और पर्टिकुलरली यदि कोई ऑथर है तो क्यों? क्योंकि उसका कॉपीराइट होल्डर है रुकले के पास होगा, वाइवा के पास होगा, विकास पब्लिकेशन, किसी ना किसी पब्लिकेशन के पास होगा. पब्लिकेशन हाउस में जाओगे तो आपको बोल देगा कि जी खरीद लो. यू कांट खरीद देयर. दैट इज द बेनिफिट हेयर. बट इसके अंदर अब ये आता है कि परमिशन तो मिल गई, लेकिन परमिशन करने के बाद जो ऑथर है, जो ऑनर है, वो कितना कंफर्टेबल है कि आप उसको किस फॉर्म के अंदर आप यूज करोगे. दैट मेक्स द डिफरेंस. दैट एंड दीज आर द 6 थिंग्स. वेरी क्विकली आई विल जस्ट एक्सप्लेन. देर आर 4 पैरामीटर्स इनटू इट. देयर BY, ऑलवेज एक्नोलेज. इफ यू डोंट एक्नोलेज इट यू मे बी डूइंग प्लेगरिज्म. और आईपीआर थेफ्ट इंटेलेक्चुअल, वैसे इन दोनों में बड़ा फर्क है, प्लेगरिज्म के अंदर और आईपीआर कॉपीराइट वायलेशन के अंदर क्या डिफरेंस है दोनों के अंदर? एक में नैतिकता आती है, एथिक्स आता है, एक के अंदर आप लॉ ब्रेक कर रहे हो, आप कानून भंग कर रहे हो एक के अंदर, दैट इज द डिफरेंस। प्लेगरिज्म देयर इज नो नीड फॉर दैट, ऑलरेडी बोल दिया उन्होंने कि जी यूज कर लो, आपको खाली नाम ही तो बोलना है कि मन्ना जी ने 2020 में इस आर्टिकल को लिखा था, हम उसको सर दें, देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी प्रॉब्लम इन दैट। After that, NC stands for non-commercial. उसके बाद बंदे ने आपको बोला कि जी आप इसको मार्केट में जाके बेच सकते हो कि नहीं बेच सकते हो, बेच सकते हो पूरा कीजिए, जहां पर NC लिख दिया उस मटेरियल को नहीं बेच सकते, फिर वो हो गया non-commercial। और जहां पे ND लग गया non derivative, means यूज करना है तो ऐसे ही यूज करना है, यू कैन नॉट रिवाइज इट। तो जिस भी लाइसेंस के अंदर ND नहीं लिखा, आप उसको डाउनलोड करके चेंज कर सकते हो अपने हिसाब से। मैं आपको वेबसाइट्स दिखाऊंगा हमारे पास टाइम होगा अभी, या वी हैव सम टाइम विद अस, सो आई विल शो यू सम लाइव वेबसाइट्स फ्रॉम देयर, वी कैन चेक दीज थिंग्स। सो एनसी नॉन कमर्शियल, जहां पे एनसी लिखा गया कमर्शियल यूज नहीं कर सकते, जहां पे एनसी नहीं लिखा उसका इवन आप कमर्शियल यूज भी कर सकते हो। यदि मन्ना जी ने कोई एक बुक लिखी जिसके ऊपर सीसी बाई लगा के उन्होंने उसको कम्युनिटी को दे दिया, आप वेरी वेल उस किताब को प्रिंट करके यदि आप उसका कमर्शियल यूज में भी चाहें, मीन्स कमर्शियल यूज उतना नहीं है कि आप उसको वैसे कर दें, आप अपने स्टूडेंट्स को नॉमिनल प्राइस के ऊपर आप इशू कर सकते हो, नो प्रॉब्लम टू इट। एंड दिस देयर इज वन मोर SA, SA स्टैंड्स फॉर शेयर अलाइक। शेयर अलाइक आपको ये कहता है, जैसे विकीपीडिया की एंट्री आप देखो, विकीपीडिया के ऊपर आप जाओ, विकीपीडिया हैज बिकम द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट ऑनलाइन एनसाइक्लोपीडिया, उसके ऊपर जितना भी पेज के एंड पे आप देखेंगे CC BY SA लिखा होता है। उसका क्या मतलब है कि ऐसा मटेरियल जिसके ऊपर CC BY SA है आप उसको यूज कर सकते हो, लेकिन आपको उसी लाइसेंस को ही रिटेन करना पड़ेगा, आप चेंज नहीं करेंगे आप उसको, क्यों? क्योंकि आपने खुद भी उसका बेनिफिट लिया है, आप आगे सोसाइटी को सेम लाइसेंस की तरह ही आप उसको आगे बांटिए। तो ये इसके फीचर्स हैं, आपको हर किसी चीज के अंदर एट्रीब्यूट करना है, साइट करना है, नाम देना है, एक्नॉलेज करना है, रेफरेंसेस में जाएगा वो, एनसी में है तो कमर्शियल यूज नहीं होगा, एनडी है तो एडिट नहीं होगा, और ऐसे है तो सेम लाइसेंस आगे फॉरवर्ड रहेगा। ये लाखों के अंदर, करोड़ों के अंदर आपको मेटेरियल मिल जाएंगे। फंडामेंटल हमारा यहाँ पर है, जब हम OER की बात करते हैं, देयर इज नो नीड फॉर यू टू री इन्वेंट द व्हील, नो नीड। यदि आप कोई ऑनलाइन कोर्स बनाना चाहते हैं, इवन स्वयं के ऊपर भी आप इसको, इसके बाद के ऊपर जोर दिया गया है कि ओपन सोर्सेज चीजों को यूज कीजिए आप, और ओपन सोर्स में तो ऑलरेडी किसी ने बना रखा, आपको तो उसको यूज ही करना है। अभी वंदना जी भी आपको बता रहे थे कि मॉडल के अंदर आप उसको डाउनलोड करके यूनिफाइड LMS जो हमने बनाना है कि हम अपना किस तरीके से चीज को बना सकते हैं, तो कोड है ना आपके पास, आप कोड को लेके उसको वो कर लीजिए। सो नो नीड फॉर यू टू रीराइट एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट देयर। There are many, many platforms available on which you can find all these things. Millions के अंदर, करोड़ों के अंदर, तादाद के अंदर चीजें इतनी भरी पड़ी हैं कि आप यदि ढूंढना चाहेंगे तो कुछ ना कुछ मिल ही जाएगा। नहीं मिलता है तो आपके लिए गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी है कि आप क्रिएट कर दो उसके लिए, और जहाँ पर आपको लगता है कि कोई गैप है, ताकि और लोग यूज कर सकें। इसका सिंपल सा एक एग्जाम्पल आपको देता हूँ मैं। न्यूटन को हम अपने इस एज का वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट साइंटिस्ट मानते हैं। उन्होंने एक बार अपने आप ही ये बोला था कि ऐसा नहीं है कि मैंने नहीं किया तो और किसी ने कुछ नहीं किया। इन मेस माई केस आई वॉज सो सक्सेसफुल बिकॉज आई कुड डू दिस थिंग्स बिकॉज आई वॉज स्टैंडिंग ऑन द शोल्डर्स ऑफ जायंट्स। दैट्स वाई रिसर्च में आप लोग भी यही करते हो। एक एक हर किसी के अंदर मोस्टली वो चैप्टर नंबर 2 होता है, रिव्यू ऑफ रिलेटेड लिटरेचर। उसको क्यों किया जाता है? देखने के लिए कि आप किसी का काम रिपीट तो नहीं कर रहे, आप ही जो कर रहे हो किसी और ही ने कर रखा है तो फिर आपको करने की जरूरत क्या है? यू नीड टू फाइंड ए गैप, एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी रिसीव दैट नॉलेज, बिकॉज समबडी क्रिएटेड फॉर अस एंड वी आर यूजिंग इट, सो वी आर स्टैंडिंग ऑन द शोल्डर्स ऑफ जायंट्स। उससे आपको ज्यादा दूर का दिखता है, आप जमीन पे खड़े हो तो कम दिखता है, ऊपर जाते हो तो ज्यादा दिखता है आपको। दैट वे दीज आर सो मेनी प्लेटफॉर्म्स अवेलेबल विच अलाउ अस टू यूज दैट। दुनिया के लगभग तमाम देश इसके ऊपर राजी हैं, क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स लाइसेंस को एग्री करते हैं, इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया, वी आर आल्सो पार्टी टू दैट। वर्ल्ड का आपको ऑलमोस्ट हर लैंग्वेज के अंदर आप जिस भी चाहें उसमें बनाना चाहें आपको मिल जाएगा। हमारा अपना इंडियन प्लेटफॉर्म भी है जिसके ऊपर ऑल इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस दे थिंग्स दे आर अवेलेबल टू अस. दीज आर दी एक्सप्लेनेशंस. आई डोंट गो इनटू इट, बट सिंपली मैंने आपको बता दिया था कि किसमें क्या. इसको पढ़ने से आपको पता लग जाएगा कि इसके तीन फॉर्मेट होते हैं इसको डिफाइन करने के, मशीन रीडेबल, ह्यूमन रीडेबल एंड लीगल लाइसेंस. लीगल लाइसेंस तो इतना लंबा होता है कोई कभी नहीं पढ़ता. आपने आज तक जितनी भी ऐप डाउनलोड की होंगी, जितने भी सॉफ्टवेयर अलाउड होंगे, मैं गारंटी ले रहा हूँ आपने कभी किसी का नहीं पढ़ा होगा. यू जस्ट हैव, और आजकल तो इतना हो गया कि जब तक आप एग्री नहीं करोगे वो इंस्टॉल ही नहीं होगा. अब डिसएग्री कर रहे हो तो कहेगा बाय बाय, आई एम नॉट इंस्टॉलिंग इट, सो यू हैव टू एग्री इट.
Interrupting you just one second. Sorry, very sorry. My most of the participants from the south side, if you will be most of the time in English, they will be comfortable. Sorry, sir. Sorry.
Okay. I was not aware. I thought that aapke hi side ke honge. Okay. So in that case, you know, it becomes very important for us to follow those things. These licenses, they are defined, they are declared in three formats. The machine readable. Means machine readables means if the license is there, you know that the barcode machine which is there and that reads it, it lets you know that what kind of that it holds. The most easy which we use is the human readable. You just see the logo, just see the icon, the image, and you will understand what is meaning of CC BY NC that way. And the legal code is lengthy code. If something goes wrong, that is for the courts to make the interpretation from there. This is the spectrum. This is the range in which we deal into the education field. On one side, education not only in terms of their education means teaching, learning, research field, where we want to learn either as formal or informal, non-formal, in any way possible there. On the one side, we have the public domain materials. Nobody holds the copyright of them. On the another side, it is completely all rights reserved. Completely copyright protected material which cannot be used unless you are obtaining it legally. You are authorized to use that. Otherwise, in between these Creative Commons licenses come. There is one more license which comes in between public domain and CC BY. That is CC 0. CC 0 is what? That the in public domain there is no copyright holder, and mostly like Ramayan, Mahabharat, stories of Munshi Premchand, etc., they go into the public domain because mostly either the, you know, it differs from country to country. After the death of the persons of 75 years, I think in India it is 70 or 75 or something like that, then the material, if the copyright has not been transferred to the heir explicitly, it will become public domain material. Nobody in CC BY, the person is there, and the person declares that I'm releasing, I'm waiving of all my copyright claims on that. You can use it. So that makes it CC 0. Within that, these six, they are there. And from the public domain, the most easy one, the least restrictive one, up to the most restrictive goes towards create the copyright protected content. So that is the range from the most simple up to the most complex one. The last two licenses of CC BY, we do not call them OER, Open Educational Resources, because you can't revise them. You can't make use of them in an edited mode that way. This is how we use them. You can see if you find a blog and the author has put the logo in there. So that is means you can use it now, depending on what authority has been released for the use of that. This is a computational neuroscience course by Paul G. Allen School in US, and they have released the whole course for you. What we can do it for here, that we can try finding a gap and create it, or we can update an existing open resource which is there. We can share our materials with us and share it. Like nowadays, if you go to a particular, a good research journal, the articles are available in various formats. You may find it is available in PDF, HTML, EPUB, MS Doc. Sometimes they don't give the MS Doc, but they try to give it, or XML format there. So variety, because the person may not have the relevant software to open that particular file from there. This is an example of how we do it. suppose you want to write a course. For that course, you have collected materials from different sources, which are Creative Commons licensed materials. What you can do, you will first, from your raw materials, you will create your first version. Once that is ready and you release it, others, what they can do, they can repurpose them, means make the things reorganized, add to your design, take out something from your design, remix the pieces and something, and make the other project. Let me give you an example. Say, for example, Mahira ji has written a poem. Now Manna ji thinks that, okay, on that poem, can I make a drama? Very well, yes, you can do it, because it is released with an open license. So the poem gets transferred to a drama. Now after that, Manjit ji is present, and Manjit thinks that, can I make a movie on this? Very well, if it is with creative, with open license, that can be done, because there is no copyright challenge into it. So you can transform, then you can translate it into different language. If it is available in Punjabi, you can translate it into English or something like that. Those things, they are possible here. Now you can see the power, that what power it offers you. But the question arises that if you are using these things, how do you know that it is of a good quality? So this British Columbia, the open campus there, they have given this evaluation criteria, 10 parameters. Not necessarily all 10 should exist in that content, but it gives a fair idea that how much comprehensive it is, how much accurate it is, what is its relevance, the clear language, there is consistency in the structure or not, and those things. On the basis of this, you can evaluate it, whether you are using the content of someone else, to find out whether that is a quality content or not for that. But when you use it, you need to cite it, because BY is there, you need to tell it. You are using it, how do we use it? Just remember this formula called as TASL. T stands for title, title of that work. Every work will have some title. Every object which exists there, they have a title. We give the names to everyone. In humans, we have our name. Everything has a title. So the title of that author, who is the owner of that, who is the holder of that, who created that, the source. If it is the print source, you have that thing. If it is online source, you can make it hyperlink. And which license, out of those six licenses, which license it holds, TASL. That is very super simple. How it is done? In this way. Suppose Andrea, this is her book. So the dog training Bible, made the dog sit there, take the photograph, and released it as CC BY. At that time, it was the version 2 of the Creative Commons license. So it was released with that. Later on, after that, Christine used that image, because it is CC BY. CC BY allows you to revise the photograph. So she put another photograph on the top of that book and took another photograph, released it now with CC BY 4.0. And that way, by citing the other work. This way, you know, we use this, and we go with this. I think if there are any questions, I can answer them. Otherwise, I will switch to some of the live websites where I can show you that from where we can get these materials which are easily available to us. We still have some time with us. Okay, are there any questions, or should I go and change my screen?
Yes, sir. I think most of the queries which were coming, even I was addressing on your behalf. And
oh, wonderful. Thank you so much.
So somebody was asking for a zero. Yeah, in the Creative Commons, about the
CC0.
Yeah.
CC0 is that, suppose you, somebody's microphone was on. If some.
Yeah.
Content, and then they think that I'm releasing it without, in even CC BY, the copyright is still retained, you know, that comes by default. Whenever a person creates anything, like there is a journal, it is called as education and science development, but if you submit your article to that, it will ask you, it will tell you that you are the copyright holder of it. Some journals, they ask you to transfer the copyright also to the publisher, to the editor. But that journal says that you retain your copyright. You just give us the license to reproduce your work on our platform. So that is the clarity from there. In CC0, the person who has created that work releases all the copyrights also. So it becomes, in a way, waving off. They are saying that, okay, I'm not holding, but the person is still present. In public domain, like we don't have Munshi Premchand with us nowadays, and the people who wrote Ramayana, Mahabharata and those things, no, means in our country also, perhaps you can check it on the internet, what is the lifetime of that, whether it is the after the death of the person, after 65 years or 70 or what, it goes into, then it becomes public domain. But here the person is still existing among us. They are releasing their copyright. That way you can make it. So
thank you, sir.
The difference here between CC BY and CC BY, CC BY you still need to cite the person. But in CC0, there is no one to cite it. Jee, another question.
The figure from a published work, if it has to be used by someone with the proper citation, is allowed or not, or he has to seek permission from author or publisher? This is one question. I think
can you please repeat the question?
I'll repeat. It's regarding the publication. Figure from a published work, if has to be used by someone with the proper citation, is allowed or not, or he has to seek a permission from author or publisher? Yeah.
If it is copyright material, say like if it is a copyright book, then definitely we need the permission from the publisher or the author, whoever is the copyright holder of that. Not even a single word technically we can use it. However, there is a way out, which we call it as fair use policy. Under the fair use policy, some portion, maybe basically we say 10% of that content can be taken, but for academic purposes only, not for commercial purpose. Commercial purpose, absolutely no for that. But it is always a good idea to obtain the permission and then use it, because that is protected by them.
Yeah, very interesting question, sir. I think I faced many times this kind of questions because I was in AICT. Sir, if any institute has my lecture video without declaration of IPR, then if I leave that institute, can they use my video afterwards? Yes, many of the faculty members do writing emails to the AICT, UGC. Sir, they are using my content. I left that. They have not given me 3 months salary even, and I am in another domain or something. So I think you are the right person to put a light on this area also. Yeah.
Technically, basically, when we are employed with some organization, and at that time, if we are creating some content, that becomes the property of that institution. Whether you stay there or not, they are free to use that till they want to use that. So even if you leave it, then if you want to go with that kind of thing, then you need to either patent it in your name, go for that kind of the technical things. In that case, wherever you will go, your patent will follow you. But otherwise, this content, I'm sorry, but because yes. you were part of that institution at that time, you were not as individual, because you use the identity of the institution also, so it will stay with that.
It's a both way, sir. I'll give you one more interesting things happening. Suppose I worked in one institution and they given me a full support to go abroad and applying for the patents, I researched papers and wrote on books. When my biodata got improved, I applied to other institution. They are looking for a NAC or NBA because they want that biodata profile. They say, okay, we'll give you 1.5 lakh package. You come and join, because your all credentials are coming along with you. We will get a marks in criteria 2 and criteria 3 of NAC as well as this. This is the common story. It's a both way. Sometimes the institutions make a misuse of the content which is retained there, or sometimes the faculty, although the institution previously have paid them a huge money to be going for the patent fee and all this kind of conferences part also there. One more thing is happening is the self-plagiarism. Can you speak some few words about the self-plagiarism? Yeah.
Self-plagiarism. Actually, what the people do, they have the habit of, in H index there, it doesn't add any value to that self-citation. There is a, let me find. It's a very interesting case of, let me try to find out. Okay, here it is. You see, this is one wonderful example on this case. There is a scientist, his name is, you may be knowing that H index was devised by John Hitch, that's why it is called as H index, yes, exactly. Which is an indication of your standing. Suppose you have written 20 publications, and they have been cited 100 times. So your H index becomes 20, something like that. Let me find the name of that person who has, Raoult. Now what he did here, in Web of Science database, Raoult has 2,053 articles published between this time to this time, having received a total of 72,000 citations, his H index is 120. उसके comparison में यदि आप Einstein का देखेंगे, तो Einstein ने total 1901 से लेके 1995 duration he got only 147 articles, which attracted 1,564 citations. Mm. On the basis of that formula, if you calculate it, it's only 1.7 means the self citations. But what he did, now let us see the case of him. The database indicated that the total citations attributed to the co-authored, out of these 18,000 were self citations. Either he was solo author or co-author or something. So if you deduct, and this amounts to 25%, so the H index will drop from 120 to 104 there.
Okay.
Self-citation is not preferred in academia. The people, you may be adding to your own thing, but those people who are in the academia, they know that you are not able to go beyond yourself. That's why every time you are citing yourself in that case. It is the point that others should cite you, rather that you are self-promoting yourself.
They should value
not,
to
not
your
taken
work.
In a,
Scoopers is
this article is an, let me, maybe I can paste it in the chat. You can, on your free time, you can surf, read it there. Jay, next.
Yeah. So it does mean that if we are going to use our own content in a future coming publications, more than certain limit, it is known to be as a self-plagiarism. Am I right, sir?
Yes.
Because
basically,
they are,
on a level of, it depends. Actually, it depends on what are total references you are quoting or the content. In a way, one or two of self-citations can be given, no problem. But if the person is citing himself or herself more than 4 or 5, definitely that may raise eyebrows.
Yes. Because sometimes we do one thing, we publish in parts, to be make more number of papers in a quantity. Already we have done one experimental work and let A to be published here, then B along with the A feedback, then AB feedback. So many papers I've seen, some of my, because sometimes we go for some unicorn kind of evaluation of NAC as an NBA. So we could see, we can correlate. So the work has been done somewhere in 10 years back, but he's still publishing the work because he wants to get the more papers to be get published, to be get some kind of, the profile upgradation or other reasons. This can be. So really, sir, it was a unique lecture today delivered by you. I'm sure, including me, all the participants, there were so many new takeaways. Because most of the my teachers, they were not aware about the Creative Commons, because when SWAM was going to be launched, it was the first time I discovered what is CC BY-NA, because SWAM was for the CC BY-NA. I especially met two, three very good advocates, and Sony Ji, one of the Supreme Court advocate. I sat along with him for 2 days because of legal vetting was going on for the one of the you know, the biggest platform of the world, that is a MOOCs platform, SWAM. So then I realized how we are unaware, and being a teacher, because I think the best content can be given by teachers only. Then only it comes to the, you know, lyrics and the movie songs. Now every day we are reading on the newspaper, he's stolen my song, and he made he's stolen my composing, you know, why he is using my song title, or maybe even a movie title, or even my dialogue also. If they are so cautious, because they have a money mind, why about the teachers not? Because today reinventing of wheel is happening, sir. I still remember, till this internet world was not there and we start our PhD, I used to go to IIT Roorkee to get the photocopies of the journals to do the literature review. And I was not knowing that something in adjacent to my college, somebody is pursuing the same kind of research. By the time the thesis came for a evaluation, the my supervisor, my examiner, who's supposed to be go for a viva, he called me personally, Manna, this same kind of thesis my student is doing in my college at Thapar. So how, sir, then you're that thing. It helped a lot to me, sir. You know, luckily, one of my friend, he made some drafting corrections. That email was with me. I brought that email to Professor Bhimra. He was a Thapar professor. Still, I remember the name because I was doing. Then he scolded his guy. Then that guy was innocent. He was not aware about this, that Manna is doing in slide Tongua. Same is happening in Thapar. He innocent. And I said, sir, no problem. I have a good sufficient thesis data. I can change my topic. I can change a little bit. Let him do, because he is already late in 3 years and he may miss his train because for me. So I delayed my thesis of M.Tech 6 months for that reason. And I allowed that guy, that is a humanitarian ground. But yes, it was the very conscious step taken by the good professors. They are very much aware, because if that time it could have been happened, sir, later some of the degree is going to be get on a stake, either mine degree or his degree. That I do. So that's why I just putting this live example to all my participants who are listening to me. This session was amazing, sir. Very informative. We should be, because tomorrow when they are going for the MOOCs creation, you know, each and every video content, which they are not going to put on a YouTube, and it is going to be through SWAM or through any kind of a Coursera or maybe edX, they should be aware about it is a copyright. They must have a royalty. If they have having a royalty, then the publisher or agency who's going to be taken of this, they can make use of this. So that's amazing. I really am really grateful to you. I think most of the participants, they are writing here on the chat box, very informative session. Thank you, sir. Great session, and all this kind of feedback is keep coming and on the chat box. So thank you, sir.
If you are not feeling hungry, just give me 5 minutes. Very quickly, sir. I want to show.
I think everybody will hear you more from you, sir. Please take 5 minutes. Thank you.
I want to show some of the websites from where you can freely use the content. No copyright, no police will chase you. So those things, I think let's first start with the people who started all this movement. And, they were the leaders into it. So this is MIT, not Maharashtra Institute of Technology, the real MIT here. These are the people who somewhere in 2000 they started with. You can find the full course and everything, the new courses which are available there. And you can, you know, say for example on chemical engineering, you can see undergraduate level, etc., principles of microeconomics. You can download this. It offers you the assignments, the lecture notes, everything fully free from here. We have one example in India, NROER. This gives you in major Indian languages the various kind of materials. Let the page come. It is taking time. It's saying transferring data. Okay, in the meantime, I will show you. Another website which I want you to search is Athabasca University Press. And one book I want to show you everyone, because we all are in online business now. You must download that book. here is the, let me see, no, NROER website. Please go to NROER on your machine, and from there you can use that. So here it is, Astha Bhaskar University Press. You can click on subject, and you see, or there is one more interesting example with this Astha Bhaskar University Press. When this university decided to offer their content as open access, open educational resources, the finance department, they were having some apprehensions that our revenue will be affected. You know what happened? When they released their material, their revenue increased, and they all were surprised, pleasantly surprised. What happened? The happening was, let me give you an example to which I am also a party. Many of you may remember that not so long ago, but sometimes ago, when you were preparing for your IAS examination, IFS examination, those kind of examinations, you used to buy NCERT material. Yes, many people I know, we used to go to the NCERT library, the book house there in the NCERT premises, and purchase the books there with the thing that, because NCERT books were so well written that you read them and then you can prepare your UPSC kind of examinations. Later on, that slot was grabbed by IGNU. So people used to come to me when I was regional director of IGNU, that sir kindly give us the history set or economic set. Why? Because we are preparing for examinations. But how this course is helping you? No sir, these books are very well written, and we read them and we can find everything. So you become a brand image. Here same thing happened. When the people, they used these books, they found that wonderful books. So it means their other material will also be good. And they started purchasing. And these are the soft copies which they were offering, not the printed copies. If you want print copies, they will still give you, but they will charge a nominal fee from you, the printing cost actually, to meet the cut. I want to show you this. You can see all these subjects on the screen right now. Go to anyone, download all open source as there. I want to show you this education online. I hope you can see now this quiz. And nowadays online assessment is very popular. Download this book. These are all free books. I want to bring you to this award winning book by Manna ji, jante honge Terry Anderson professor, wonderful person from Canada. There he has written this book of theory and practice of online. You can download, this is award winning book. This book has been downloaded in PDF and translated in more than 60 languages of the world. This is in English, but it has been translated into other languages. You can see it has four parts. It tells you theory, it tells you infrastructure, it tells you design online courses and delivery and assessment part. And see here, this book is under Creative Commons. You cannot make a commercial use, but you can reproduce it for your own students and give them. And similarly, many other, you will find so many subjects available there. Two more websites which will be good for you. One is OpenStax. And those of you who are from engineering or those subjects, you are going to love this website. These are full 100% free textbooks, not articles, complete textbooks. You can see the subjects here, mathematics, science, social science, humanities, etc. You click on anyone here, peer reviewed, openly licensed, 100% free. Say this book is on history. You can click on it and then can download the PDF. Not only that, if you think that out of 10 chapters, only 2 chapters are required for you, it depends on the license. Let us say this is CCBY. BY means you are allowed to revise the chapters. Download it, modify it to your need, and use that, completely allowed under 4.0. Another one, it is Open Textbook Project of Hong Kong. Here, this site offers books for all the levels. Bachchon se leke, from primary up to the tertiary, find and wonderful books. Hey, let me just quickly show you. Okay, here you can see the subjects. I'm just clicking on business. So accountancy, and you can read it. This is one of the free open textbook for tertiary level. Please feel free to use it, adopt it, and modify the content to your own needs. The only request which they say, please read it, release it with data, because you used it for there, and it is CC BY-SA. That's only thing which request. So if you are teaching accountancy, use this book. You don't need to write it. You want to create your video, use the content into it and create your own video for that. So whole list is there. So this is about the text. There are many others also. I'm just showing you the major from which you can download them. Now let me show you. You want to make PPT. You want to create your a course. For that you need images. What we do, we go to the Google, make a search, find, oh, this image is very good, let me download it. That's a wrong approach. You can't do that. You should not do that. Actually, what should we do in that case? There are certain websites which help you. One is Pixabay. There you see here, stunning free image, royalty free stock. And say, for example, if you want to search something on leaf, you just type your leaf. You want to make give some lesson on, say, photosynthesis, and you think that, okay, this image is good, I want to show that how that is used. So you click on that particular image and see on the right, it says here free for commercial use, and one step further, no attribution required. It means the author is here, what is the name, jo bhi name hai. But if you want to use this image, you want to print it, make it a banner and go to Lal Kila and sell it in 10 rupees, perfectly fine with this person or with this platform. And secondly, if you don't want to cite even, go ahead. Ethically, however, I will request you that please, you can at least give this URL if you are using making your own present, because that is the ethical issue. There is no shame and harm in acknowledging the work of someone else if we are using that in our work there. So Pixabay. Another site which I use very regularly is Unsplash. And here you can see internet source of freely usable images. And from the here on the upper top, you can see so many of the, you know, it is offering you texture, current event, people, whatever you want to find, you can find it. If you want to give some lesson on wildlife, just type, say, lion. And you want to use any picture, say for example this one, I like it, I want to use it in my work. You see, you click here, you can click on download from there, and this is the free download allowed to be used by you there. Another is Fotter has something interesting thing why I want to show you. And see the number quantity, is just check 335 million kitna ho gaya, crore mein chala gaya. Why? We don't need to plagiarize or steal anyone's. These are available to us. So here I want to say, and here you can see by default they have given by categories. What do you want to search? Something for education, and in that on idea wise, what do you want to search? Something. Just click on, say for example, we want to go for education, and okay, I'm giving some lecture on online education. And I want to use this image, Bacha Wala. So I will click on it. Just see the beauty of this website now on this right. It allows you not only to download it, but it allows you to even embed it. Now, embedding is very good for your learning management system. Shayad Vandana ji ne aapko bataya hoga jab Moodle ki hum Google Classroom ki hum baat karte hain. Download mein to hota, pehle download kar rahe ho, fir upload kar rahe ho. It is involving your bandwidth. It is occupying your server space also. 200 MB में से यदि 50 MB किया तो 150 बच गया आपका, 50 चला गया. But here it allows you to, it will give you an embedding code. In embedding code, zero space you occupy because the original source is still somewhere else. Then it is showing you the license, modification allowed. So आपने, if you want to put a cap on the head of this बच्चा to make it more attractive, it is allowed. Modifications, you can change something in this program. And if you want to give attribute, there is the ready link. Just simply use that for your work. So that way it goes into it. Now for this, for images, for music, because we want to add certain background music to our presentations or our video. Aur aapko yaad hoga, Manna ji ne jo swayam ka platform banaya, uske liye aapki ek requirement bhi hai ki aapko not more than 3 minutes, you need to submit an introductory video for your course. And sometimes in introductory video, we may like to have some background music into it. And music is very serious business. That's why the charges have been leveled against, say, for example, Anu Malik, that he goes to Rajasthan or Punjab, listens to the folk music, comes back to Mumbai, creates in, and uses them. These things, they go on. It's a very serious business. So we don't need to do that because we have SoundCloud with us. You can go to that and download there because there is a free music on available there. And in South, I'm just running, I'm not opening more things. You just need to write these resources and later on you can explore. It is simply opening it and finding it. Another source is Jamendo music, that is very popular. It is free music. You can see that so many things they are available to you from there, and free streaming, free. You can find what is latest, what is the best, what is the trending into it, and all genre, all kind of whatever you think you want to use it, it is available there. For simulations, there are two good resources. PHET simulations, they are the world popular simulations, and these are completely free and they work wonderful. They are coming up on the screen. So these are the free, and you can say if you click, okay. Actually, ये जो इसका window है ना, go to meeting का ये मेरे screen को घेर लेता है. You can see here by clicking on simulations, you have for physics, chemistry, mathematics, earth science, biology, etc., etc. So many things. Let's say some simple example. If I click on chemistry, I'm just at random taking. Although I am MSc chemistry and NMR spectroscopy was my specialization when I did my MSc. And here you can see alpha decay. Okay, this one, let's take balloon and static electricity. This is a simulation on it. It is developed with HTML5. There you can download it and use it. You can embed it in your work. It will very well go. Embed anywhere, including Moodle. But if you are using Google Classroom as your LMS, directly it will go into your Google Classroom. Simply click it. From here, it will open the window and it will ask you that in which of your class you want to edit it. From here, you can select, choose a class in whatever classes you have, you simply, and it will be posted there. If you want to play it, you can to see that how it works. You can simply click on it. They are wonderful things. Means they work completely. Okay, it may take some time. Okay, here you can reset, you can have the balloon, which balloon is there. After that, you can, you know, you charge it and see, oh, the charge particles on the wall, they are changing it accordingly, the how many charge particles they are there. And then, you know, you it changes here. You come near to it, is something like if you have your comb and you see there, and then some paper pieces. Maybe in childhood, everyone must have done that. And you try to lift those to show the charge particles into it. These are the live things which are available to us. One more is Oscar simulations by IIT Mumbai. Oscar IIT Mumbai. Let me see, perhaps this one will be there. Okay, so here you can go, and this is the open, yeah, here you can find the repository. They have many activities and on, but this is for science only. It's the physics, chemistry, computer science, mathematics, those areas, not for humanities, etc. You can find them. Now I want to show you the BAP of every search engine, the Google. How can we use it for that? For video, to search for video, when normally what we do, we just go to YouTube, type our search and find any YouTube and use it. Completely wrong approach, because on YouTube the videos are of two types: standard YouTube license and Creative Commons license. The standard YouTube license prohibits us its use unless we have the permission to that. So how to do that? You simply go to YouTube, and if you want to make a search, say for example, let the page come on photosynthesis, the normal searches, it will show you may or may not be the, say for example, let us say this video, and where to find it? Here in the description area, you can find and say show. Nowhere they have mentioned that this video is allowed as a reuse. So it means in that case, this one is a copyright protected. We, officially, we cannot use it unless we obtain the permission from this by writing to them, by approaching them. In that case, what we need to do, again, go back to your search, and the process is super simple. You need to just aware of this filter button. This won't come unless you make a search in YouTube. By default, it won't be there. You need to search your keyword, and then automatically it will be activated. You click on this, and here you see under features, there are other features also. I don't need to explain to them, but go for this Creative Commons. Click on it, and now these results which you get, they are Creative Commons video licenses. You know, you can check, let's say at random, you can click on anything and go to the you know, description here. See here, Creative Commons reuse allowed. Reuse means now you can reuse it without seeking the, without writing to them. Now they have allowed it, and here you can see view the attributions, the video source. You can click on it, and it will take you to its original source from here, that it is California Academy of Sciences. Like that, you can use it. This is it. For videos, there is another good resource, which is TeacherTube. I'm not sure how many of you know it. TeacherTube. You, here you can read it. This is as like we define democracy. Government by the people, of the people, for the people. There also logos the same thing. The videos by the teacher, of the teacher, for the teacher. So this is TeacherTube, created by the teachers for the teachers. So you can see various subjects. You can have them. It has videos, it has audios, it has other lessons created by the teachers. Another one, again, I'm going back to MIT now. There, I like this website, MIT Blossoms. Why I like this website, I will show it to you. But first of all, this is open source. Completely written here, blended learning, open source, science and mathematics. So those of you who are from science, very well use it. And in many languages of the world, you can see all the languages, including Malay. This is flag of Malaysia there, where I was teaching some time ago. All these videos, you can click on any video at random, say, go for this physics, recognize forces. This is the beauty of this website, which I like. It allows you to download, and it gives you the transcript. You can download the transcript of the video. Now, what is the benefit of transcript is that there may be certain people, if you are not able to, you know, understand the listening thing, you give the transcript to the people. Because transcript, anybody can read it at any time. It shows you there. So there, and so these are the informations. And the last, Google search engine. Ultimately, if you don't remember these so many websites which I have told you, the Google Baba is there. Go there and use it either in two ways. Ultimately, if you have to visit Harmandir Sahib, wherever you go, ultimately you will be reaching Asrul Mandir. There are various ways to go that. So ultimately, what we will be doing, either you go to Google Advanced search by directly going to Google Advanced search using this page, we will be landing. Or otherwise, if I use, say for example, photosynthesis, if I type in my, it is showing me the normal thing. From here, from the settings, I can go to Advanced search. Ultimately, I have to reach this page, Advanced search. Now here lies the power of Google. Those of you who are from science or maths, you may be knowing a word called as Boolean search. B-O-O-L-E-A-N, Boolean search. What is that Boolean search? There are certain keywords like and. If I say that temple and Amritsar, so it means it will show me those results in which the temples are in Amritsar, and it will combine both. If I say or, temple or Amritsar. It will show me in which, either temple or Amritsar, or maybe both, they may be there. If I say temple space minus Amritsar, it will show me all the temples, but not Amritsar will come. These are called as Boolean search. They add to the power of that. Then you can find any language, more than 200 languages are there. Any region of the world you want to search for a particular region, particular time, here is the thing which is at the end I want to tell you, go there. And here you can see what you want to search, whether it is free to use, share, you want to make a commercial use of that, you want to modify, depending on these conditions, you select it and then click on advanced search on this key term. Now these results, they will be reported back to you. You can click on it, say for example, if I click on it, at random I'm clicking on it. Hopefully it will open fast. Yeah, it is saying something, transferring data. Okay, here it is, this resource. These are the learning objects. Here you see all of the thing there, and see license. CC BY, under Creative Commons Attribution. What it says, bhai sahab, just take my name. After that, if you want to update this material for your own purpose, you are free to use that. Okay, now Manaji, I'm stopping my screen. Maybe our friends, they are hungry, and sir, they may be beating me that you took more time.
Including me and all participants, I think nobody was there to say you to stop. You believe or you not believe it, sir, not even a single participant dropped, because this is the content, this is the information for which I think we are thirsty from many, many years. I am in a teaching profession from last 27 years. Many of the participants must be more than senior to me, because the true things, you know, in my country, India, although we have a shastras and granthas, but we don't have the proper preachers or teachers, the translation. I cannot read a grantha, because if I don't know the proper Sanskrit, then somebody will come in between to do the marketing of it. And they serve something else. They are going to make me to scare from the Mangal and Shani. Although Mangal and Shani is my devtas, you know, my gods. Yeah. But they no, you put this Dan, otherwise the Mangala is coming on your head or Shani is coming on your head. This is the reality. Yes. The true teacher does mean Vidya Vicharita Parupkari. You made it, sir. You made it. Many of the teachers, they keep the knowledge with them only because they don't want to share at all. It is from the school level. When I was in a seventh standard, one of my classmates, she was a monitor, she was not showing me the Hindi copy that day. I forgot to do the homework, and before, after recess, I was supposed to be show my homework. She could not show, and she succeeded, and I got, you know, flatter on my this hand also. That time it was there in a footer. I joined AICT. After 1 month, I made a call through my PS to that one, my classmate. She is still assistant professor somewhere. I don't have to name or something. After, she is my batchmate. Yeah. She was a monitor. I said, even not sharing your Hindi copy, I could become a director. I said, you are still assistant professor. That's it. I just wanted to convey. That's it.
Very recently, I read a very beautiful thing somewhere that you cannot give unless you have that thing.
Yes.
That absolutely. Is also there.
Absolutely.
If you don't have anything, you cannot give it.
Yes.
You can give only when you have it.
When you have it. Truly, when you have it, when you truly earned it, you grasp it. If it is even copied by you, then you will be also, you know, not comfortable, or you will be scared. Oh, yes. I met stuck up in between because I am not aware about 2Z. ABC, everybody knows. Everybody says I'm a master in my computers and my AI. When I ask the simple definition of the AI, none of them can be justify me this because they have just gone through with the cream, the ice of the cake. They have never seen the base of the cake. That is the fact, sir. And really, I salute you, sir, for it's a very dynamic, very informative lecture. And you taken my request within a simple WhatsApp message, and you allowed me to be taken your name and to this. All my speakers are really very eminent. I am really feel proud that I have connected with you people. I could bring you people before my participants, and the participants will definitely remember this FDP in coming years also. This retention is going to be a long way, sir. I wanted to make a unique FD. That's why I'm just doing it. Even my organizers from NIT or from SLIT must be understanding the value of this FDP. I can excuse my today's my session, because afternoon is my session. I have taken this privilege. I will allow all the participants to come at 2:30 only instead of 2. No problem. I understand you need 1 hour because many of my, you know, my female participants, they have to cook first, then they have to serve to the kids also. So I can understand. No problem. Don't be in a panic. You come at 2:30. I request Dr. Mahiraj to please propose a vote of thanks and gratitude. Although there is no words to give a thanks to you, sir, for your amazing talk. Yes. Thank you.
Professor. I have pasted some of my website links.
Taking photograph and they are capturing, and we are sharing with them through our Google Classroom. We have already created a Google Classroom, sir. All the data, even your PPTs, I'm going to request you to send your PPTs, which I'm going to Google Classroom. So all the participants will take away all the beautiful things. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Over to Dr. Mahiraj, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Manna, sir. Sir, thank you very much, sir, for giving such a fruitful and wonderful lecture. Even I was also not aware of these sites where we can copy that content and that will be not licensed, this one. So that is very informative to us. And in today's area, we are in the teaching profession and we are publishing very research papers and we are publishing some books also where we have not to copy from the other resources. That is very important topic for all the participants and all with us, all the teachers with us. So very thankful to you, sir, for giving such a very nice lecture to us. Thank you very much, sir.
I must appreciate you that I think you prepared it even before my session was over. I won't name one university. You will be laughing at it. I gave a session, took a session in some university, and it was my whole day session. Here it is only one session. Yeah. They took 4 months just to send me a simple letter. Forget about the certificate. But here you are. My session is yet to be finished, but you prepared it. So thank you so much.
We feel proud to be giving appreciation, although you are appreciated by the whole world, sir. And by all the participants will take you today as a role model. And I'm sure they are going to connect you through your Facebook or through your LinkedIn or maybe through your YouTube. They are going to be chase me for your even contact number, everything. And you'll be going to be different. Sir, my participants here, Pan India, sir. Somebody's from Kerala, somebody's from Joharat, somebody's from Manipur, and somebody's from Punjab, Mandi Govindgarh even. So, sir, I have taken this holistic approach for this FDP because we have to create, district teachers. We have to create because every time you and me cannot reach. So now they are going to become trainer and they will execute the same kind of material in their campuses, respective places, and to take it a long way, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much to be joining us and delivering this. I will be bothering you again and again because many such FDPs are going to be come on the way. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank
always
you very
welcome.
Much.
Thank you. Bye, everyone. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, dear participants, quickly before I'm going to switch off to the morning session, the session 3, session 2 feedback already has been sought from you on a Google Classroom. Everybody have to write at least 100 to 250 words. What basically you liked more and how was the session? For this session, I'm going to ask you the feedback. It is an assignment. Everybody have to submit this assignment. So now I'm not wasting more time. Though I have not joined the Google Classroom, I will quickly show you the link for the Google Classroom again here on the screen. And I think most of them, you have already joined Google Classroom. If you have not joined it, so you please see the link over here. Join the Google Classroom. 98 participants are there, but here I'm looking more than 120 participants. Other have to join. If you don't know how to join, I will guide you. See you at 2:30 sharp. Be with me, and we are going to have more beautiful sessions in coming days. Thank you very much to all of you.
Bye.
And have a good lunch. Come with the full energy. Bye. Thank you, sir. Thanks again.
Thank you for the informative session.
Thank you.